Clark Duncan.
Hello! Welcome, everybody, to the Gauntlet here on Hyper RPG. I'm your host, Rai, gonna kill him real bad over and over again, guy.
Yeah,
I made that up on the spot, could you tell? This is the Gauntlet. Alright, so what that means is our contestants today are gonna have 2 hours to run through our dungeon, hoping to get the high score. And if they do so, of course, they will claim our prize and be immortalized inside the Yojimbo for generations to come. Did you even know you guys were playing for that?
I did not. That's crazy.
There's also a $1 million prize that's completely fictional. Now, of course, you in the audience can participate. If you are feeling like, being charitable, you can send them a potion, hashtag potion, when you tip $25, and they will get one random potion from the potion deck, which will give them a big advantage over the course of this gauntlet. Or if you want to have real fun, and if you want to make my day, send them a trap. So hashtag trap, that means that they will get pummeled, bruised, battered, and shattered by a randomly generated trap from our trap matrix. There are many different effects, many different forms of damage that they will take in new and excruciating and embarrassing ways. As well, we have a new feature to the gauntlet where if maybe you're feeling like a brewmaster or a trap architect, you can actually tip $50 and send us your own trap or your own potion idea, and I will make it happen, and then I will permanently add it to the deck for future contestants through the gauntlet. Now, as well, every single subscriber we get during the gauntlet will earn the team here one auto res. That's a resurrection that they get to just use for free, and they'll definitely need it. Otherwise, they'll be sitting out 2 rounds before they get to actually be useful after death. So that's actually a huge advantage for them when they gain that. Plus, you get to see, which is always fun to do. I've seen all of these, I think I've seen everyone here dance, and let me tell you, you will be delighted. Now, as well, I think that is pretty much everything. That is how it's gonna work. Guys, coming up next, of course, it's Cineverse at 7:30. If you haven't seen the show, it's awesome. It covers all the latest film and TV and media news with Adam, Augie, Erica, and Hector Navarro of famed answer to all Trivia Hops questions. That'll only make sense to some of you. Now anyways, before we start interviewing him, let's cue up that sweet graphic. Let's play the intro. This is the Gauntlet.
Gauntlet.
Oh, that's so cool.
Oh yeah! That music comes on. You know what time it is. All right, guys. To my left here, we have the wizard Fido. Fido, why don't you tell us about yourself? Who are you? Why the heck are you here?
Oh my gosh, I just, here, can I read my little sheet?
Sure.
Yeah, so like, I'm a...
Fido, there is a special magical
viewing
glass on you. There's a
camera right. Oh my gosh, there's a camera. Guys, I'm a wizard. Hi, my name is Fido. I'm a wizard. I can photo, my power is that I can photosynthesize. And so I can make food for me and all of you through the power of the sun. I'm just here to make some friends, though. So,
really?
Yeah.
Even though that, like, if you lose, you'll be, like, eternally, you know, contained here, if not outright killed immediately for failure.
I was not aware of this.
Oh, okay.
I was here to just make friends, and now I'm getting a little stressed out.
Sorry to be the bearer of bad news. Just kidding, I'm not sad about it at all. Now, to your left, who do we have here with all the fur?
I am Helga She-Wolf Whistle, and I am one with the animals. I was raised by wolves, and I live in the forest with all of my little woodland companions, but they're like really fierce ones. Even the otters are like really like bloodthirsty, like badass, scary, fierce otters, and I wear their fur.
Wait, so you protect them, but you also, like, harvest their hides and wear them as trophies on your body?
Only when they die of natural causes.
Oh, so sustainably harvested.
Yes.
Animal furs. Okay.
Yes, free
and
trade.
Do you come from a long... Fido, do you have something to say about that?
She just said free trade, and I like that.
Thank you.
Oh, boy. All right, thank you, Fido. So, do you come from a long line of She-Wolf Whistles, or was that even your name?
Helga She-Wolf Whistle. It's all one word. And I don't know because I was raised by wolves. My lineage is a little bit mysterious. I was found as a youngling in the woods, and the wolves were like, let's hang out with this creature and teach her our ways and eat the afterbirth off of her.
Wow, that is a delightful story. Thank you so much for sharing all those details I didn't ask for. Now to your left, who do we have here with the big axe?
I am Chunkers.
Was it Chunkers or Chunkers?
Chunkers. Chunkers the Barbarian.
Interesting. Is that your full name?
Yes.
Where do you come from, Chunkers?
The Chunker tribe. I am the queen of the Chunkers, the chunkiest of the Chunkers, and I am the original Chunker.
So it's kind of a, is it sort of a caste system
based
on?
No, I'm just very chunky.
Okay.
The chunkiest of the Chunkers becomes a Chunker.
It's weird, I had not heard about such an idiosyncratic tribe
before.
I did
not laugh at my own identity. I am the Chunker queen of the Chunker Barbarians.
Very well. And what brings you to the gauntlet today?
I must protect the Chunker tribe with my chunky axe and my chunky bandit, which you will meet in a second.
Okay, yeah, I understand. Barbarians have limited vocabularies.
Hey, you know what? No. The chunky barbarians are suffering because they're not chunky enough.
It's quite an epidemic, actually.
Stop laughing.
What a great point.
Worse.
I hadn't thought of that before. Thank you so much for sharing. Now, to your left, who do we have here?
I'm the Potato Bandit, and this is my protector, Chunkers.
You're the Potato Bandit?
The one and only.
This is a title? Who has bestowed this title upon you?
The law.
The law.
The authorities.
So you're wanted.
Maybe?
Maybe? What kind of crimes have you allegedly committed?
Well, allegedly I steal things and replace them with potatoes.
Hence the name.
So, yeah, because potatoes are great, and so are things that other people have and I don't.
And so how are you related to this motley crew we have here? How did you guys all meet?
Chunkers is my my protector. We like to hang out. We were wandering in the woods, and we saw these two.
Fido and I actually host a weekly program for the woodland animals.
And community at large.
Like a play?
A little bit. It's like a talk show with the animals. It's called Off the Tails, and they happened to run into us while we were hosting our weekly session to catch up on the goings about of the forest where I live.
I could not have said that better myself.
I mistaked Helga for my chunky wolf, Bob.
Yeah.
And I realized that she is not a chunky wolf. She's a very small, violent woodland creature.
I'm sure they look very much alike. So now, what do you all plan on doing? I mean, Fido, what would you do if you won tonight?
For the plants! I would use that money to be able to travel and hype plants and just be like, guys, hello, plants. They produce oxygen. They get their own food. There's a lot to learn about these. That's what I would
do. I've never heard anything about plants producing oxygen before. I have no idea what you're talking about actually at all.
Photosynthesis.
Never heard of it.
What? This is crazy.
Sounds like you really need the money.
Okay. I do.
Okay, and what was she? Wolf Trap?
Helga. It's fine. It's fine.
Okay. Yes.
It's
whatever. What are you gonna do if you win the gauntlet tonight?
I want to use the funds from my winning to create a larger forest sanctuary for my sweet animal companions, and then maybe start a traveling circus with them.
Ooh.
But like a very humane one. And maybe get a haircut. Very hot.
Okay, and
money!
Sure. And Chunkers, you're kind of already pointed out that this was gonna be for your tribe, but
yes, they must get chunkier.
Okay, so you know, more turkey legs for everybody.
And potatoes.
And
chunky potatoes.
The potato
really delicious potatoes.
Potato Bandit, is there anything you would do with our $1 million prize?
I would pay off my bounty so that I can wander the streets again without being assaulted by officers of the law. And I would also help assist Chunkers and her tribe to get more chunky.
Wow. Well, you technically still win most reasonable, I think, answer to that question for today. So congratulations. That offers you no points or special benefits, but
it's fine.
You know,
plants aren't reasonable.
I'll steal the points. Can I steal points?
We're all in this together. All on a team now. So in case you didn't catch that earlier, you're all on a team now. You've been brought together. You're trying to get the high score, and we are about to begin. So we've got the time loaded up on the clock here. As soon as that starts, we will not be pausing it. You will have 2 hours, and that's it, to complete your mission here, which is to, of course, gain all the skulls you can. Are you ready?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Woo! Yes.
All right, let's start the clock as you materialize into the winner's lounge here. You will see there's a fountain of gold in the center.
Ooh.
And as well, four beautiful golden statues commemorating past winners. All right, Fido, what would you like to do now that you've entered the room?
Oh my gosh. Like, look around and go, wow, look at all those gold statues.
Yeah, do you want to inspect them? Do you want to try to steal some gold shavings off them? What are you
Yeah, gold shavings. Do I have a cheese grater or anything? Like,
you tell me, Fido.
Yes, I do. I have a cheese grater for this exact moment.
For this exact reason, to steal gold.
Yeah, just gold shavings. I'm not stealing gold bars.
No.
Just gold shavings.
All right, well, do you want to move your miniature on the map to the statue that you're stealing from?
Okay, here we go. Okay, I'm going to steal from the guy with two hammers.
Oh, excellent. All right, so as you approach the statue with the two hammers raised, you start applying pressure with the cheese grater to its sleeve, and let's see how much gold you get. Yeah, so it looks like as you start grating against his arm, the two hammers just suddenly fly through the air, smashing you across
no!
the chest. You take 5 points of damage
no!
as it is very much alive and very angry that you would try to grate it. And now you can tell the other contestants see that the other statues are looking angry and menacing, and then they, in fact, might actually be moving and breathing and are very much alive. That brings it over to our next contestant, Helga. What are you going to do after seeing this?
Alright, so I'm feeling a little bit concerned about the fact that there's a big scary golden statue moving towards me, so I am going to go ahead and fire a warning shot with my arrow. So.
Okay, alright, so roll a d20 here, and let's see how you do. And yeah, you took 7 damage.
7, so 42.
Mm-hmm. Whoops. Oh, what'd you get? A natural 1. Okay, that's a huge failure. Let's see what happens with that. Oh my gosh, the arrow is going to go flying, and it's actually going to land, it's going to go past the statue and strike Jim.
What?
Or sorry, Fido. I have no idea who Jim is.
What?
Did
Man.
I do that?
Luckily, Jim, it just grazes across your cheek, making it, oh! Let it be a trap.
Fido looks shifty-eyed and likely to murder the entire party. I think this is wonderful, so a hashtag potion for Fido.
Thank you!
Ooh.
Yay! I get a potion!
This is for you, buddy.
Hooray!
Fido,
you
earned it.
Blue potion!
But also, why was that not a trap?
Huh?
No, go ahead and drink it.
So drink this, is it? What is this?
Oh, we're gonna you tell me, man. How's it taste? Glug glug. Bottoms up.
Don't potion-y.
Potion.
As Pee-wee would say.
Perhaps you taste a hint of bone ash.
Bone ash?
Please read what you just consumed.
Ooh, a skull smoothie. That's what it was. Dang. I was tasting some other stuff too. Gained 2d12 skulls.
Wow, that's great. That is actually one of the best potions in the deck.
Yay!
Yes, unfortunately.
Yay!
You get to roll 2d12, so roll a d12 once and then again to see how many skulls you get without even killing an enemy yet. Reminder, hashtag trap to send traps which hurt them and hinder them.
Okay.
We need another
d12. Still waiting.
Okay, should I just roll
it twice?
Okay, I'll just roll it twice.
Yep. That's all it takes. Let's see. Oh my gosh! Yeah.
Wait, is that good?
Yeah, it's good.
Yay! I should probably never go to Vegas.
You got a 12 on the D12. Doesn't get any better than that.
7!
Yeah!
Cool!
Very good. So you did just take an additional point of damage as that arrow just comes across your cheek as you duck out of the way and opens up a tiny little cut.
I'm sorry, Fido. I didn't.
I'm like Nelly, kind of, like with the. Yeah. I need a band-aid. Just like
whoever Nelly is. All right, Chunkers, seeing as your teammate is now under fire from your other teammate, what would you like to do?
I would like to attack the chunkiest of the gold statues.
All right, you tell us which one that is.
This dude.
Ooh, now you can only move up to 6 tiles at a time, so you'd have to double move and you wouldn't be able to attack.
No, that's 6.
Oh, no. Wait, really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, then go ahead and do it.
No, it's not. Okay, then I'm going to tiny chunkers.
All right.
Tiny chunkers.
So you leap to action, running after that statue, wielding the 2 golden hammers to save Fido.
Using my trusty chunk axe.
Are you going to be making a power attack by any chance?
Is that okay?
It's great.
Okay. I'm really mad, so.
Yeah, you should be.
I'm going to get him.
All right, let's see that D20 go rolling. What's it going to be?
13.
13, all right. And what's your hit on that? I believe your power attacking, I believe that's a 14. Remind me if I'm
where?
Right on that. On your character sheet there should be power attack.
-4 to hit.
All right.
What?
But you start out at a +18, I believe.
Yes.
Because that character is pretty powerful.
Yeah.
All right, congratulations. So the axe just comes smashing through the statue and it just gets rent right in half and both sides just fall over and shatter on the ground. Remove that statue from the board and then roll 1d6 to see how many skulls you get as you claim your first kill of the night.
And I'm just over there looking like a loser with my cheese grater, like, thanks.
2.
2. All right, you're up to 21 skulls.
Fuck.
Not bad, not bad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Congratulations. Now, that means it is off to the Potato Bandit.
All right. So I am going to try to sneak behind this guy and do a little stealth kill.
All right. So you've got about 6 tiles of space you can move unless you want to double move. So be careful. Might be tricky to get that sneak attack in.
Yeah, as long as it's 6.
Yeah.
All right, and then roll that attack. What are you using as a weapon? You don't use a potato as a weapon, do you?
Got my trusty dagger.
Oh, okay, that makes sense. Yeah. To peel the potatoes. All right.
Yeah.
It would have been ridiculous if you were a potato bandit that used a potato as a weapon. That would have been
silly. And I would run out of potatoes.
Yeah, that's true. You wouldn't have any.
And I would bloody the potatoes, and that would be sad because then you can't eat them.
Because then the chunkers would starve.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah, what do you think?
It would be a potato famine. Alright, let's see how you do on this one.
I got a 4.
You got a 4, that's not very good. What's your to hit on that?
8.
Ooh, I'm afraid you are gonna just barely miss. So as you get in position, you're like kind of sort of climbing up the side of that fountain filled with gold that no one ever seems to like try to dig into. But whatever. Yeah, it seems like you kind of catch a rock a little wrong and stumble forward and just barely miss.
Ah,
just barely.
A little clumsy. I'm clumsy.
But now it's time for the statues to get revenge. And also, it's time to unleash the first trap of the night. This one was purchased ahead of time.
Oh, no.
Oh, they do not sound happy about that. But I'm excited. So you start to feel the ground shake beneath you, you start to hear this great clattering on the stone tile. And all of a sudden, rushing through, I guess they must have been coming through the swamp, it's hard to say, but at first you see one rider appear on a pink fluffy unicorn. There's a goblin, bareback on it, and it is leading a charge of pink fluffy unicorns that go running through the room, smashing into everyone in sight, and these are stinky light fluffy unicorns as well, so they're going to be doing some additional damage. Everyone needs to make a fortitude save right now, so everyone roll a d20, please, and let me know what you get.
I got a 10.
What's your fortitude modifier? Your save.
It is 4.
Ooh.
I got a 5.
Oh, yeah, you're done.
You're dead.
No, you're not dead, don't worry.
I got a six. Wait, is that a six or nine?
Oh, yep. Plus your fortitude save is pretty high as the barbarian.
It's nine.
And you got a six?
Yeah.
All right. Hey, one person has succeeded here.
I got a 10.
Oh.
And fortitude is 4.
Oh my gosh. I don't know what happened, but as these fluffy unicorns are charging through the arena, they are releasing some deadly flatulence. Each of you who has failed, that's everyone besides besides Chunkers, takes in this foul stench and is just overcome with waves of nausea. On your next turn, you will vomit instead of
I am used to flatulence.
Instead of attacking.
Wow.
Yeah. That's pretty brutal.
Vomiting.
On top of that, you will each also receive 13 points of damage as the unicorns collide into you. Anybody dead yet?
39.
All right, I'll work on that.
29. Oh, no!
All right, so now the scythe-wielding statue is going to charge right at Helga, who's in the corner and has just let loose that arrow. If you could move that statue for me,
this
Helga.
One?
Yes, that's going to be charging right at you in the corner. Excellent. So that one is going to make an attack. Let's see how it goes. Ooh, that's going to be great. You're going to take 9 points of damage as it starts cutting into you with that
scythe. But don't I like throw up on its face or something and its eyes? How can it be?
You throw up all over it. You projectile vomit. Are you good at the projectile? There it is. All right, that's what I was going to say. So you projectile vomit all over the statue, but it doesn't matter because it's a golden animated statue, and then it just stabs you like across the chest and it hurts real bad. Yeah. Sorry. Now, the next statue, the one with the spear raised triumphantly and the sword in one hand, is going to charge into Fido from behind. Fido, if you could move that statue into place.
Wait, where? Sorry?
In the back. So you see that golden statue with the spear and the sword?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, if you could move that right behind you for that delicious backstab.
Oh, gosh.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no.
It's not good.
Call me Julius Caesar, because this is going to be awful.
I have good news. So it gets into position, and it slices downwards with the spear in this kind of awkward thrust that like looked more heroic than it was effective, and it just kind of nicks you in the back of the ankle, and you take 1 point of damage.
Ooh, just a little nicky-poo.
Just a nick.
Alrighty.
You've been pretty lucky. Now the final statue is going to turn around to face the potato bandit assailant and try to get revenge with a thrust from that short sword. Let's see what happens. Ooh, that's going to be a miss as you duck and dive out of the way.
Yeah.
No problem there. That means, well, everyone is throwing up right now except for Chunkers.
The flatulent queen.
You guys, you can move if you want. You just won't be able to make an attack this round.
Okay.
You do that if it's important.
Oh, yeah, I want to make a move.
Maybe get out of harm's way.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Woo. All right.
I'm guessing we're entering
I'm
this
also
room.
Scooting. Yeah, I'm also scooting.
Scoot
back.
Away.
I move right behind this barrel and I crouch.
It's probably not full of explosives.
Well, you know, I guess we'll find out now, won't we? But that's what I do. And I feel confident in my choice. Lions do not concern themselves with the opinions of sheep.
All right, Chunkers. Ooh,
wow. I believe I am the leader of this weak group.
It's true, you are team leader now.
So I am going to move forward to become the queen of the next room.
Oh, and she enters through the door.
You're just leaving us.
As you do so, the fangs hanging from the top of that mouth-like opening extend downwards. Please make a reflex save right now. Roll a d20, add your reflex.
Ooh.
And I eat them.
And see what happens.
With a 13.
All right, plus your reflex, you should be fine. The fang extends down, but just misses you.
Wow.
Maybe note that for next time you go under there. Now, as you enter the room full of sulfur and smoke and the bubbling, oozing lava pit in the center of the room, you feel the heat all around you, and emerging out of the center of the lava pit are two favorites. It's gonna be none other than Blaze and Buddy.
That bastard.
Oh yeah.
His dumb friend.
Uh-oh.
Ooh.
Mm-hmm. Oh, man.
So he's right here. Just
look at the graphics for that. It's just like the tale of the tape going on over here.
That's right. So Blazin' Buddy, roar forth from the fire.
Hey, you want to play?
Buddy, Blaze, please, maybe these will be the adventurers who don't mean us any harm. So the big one kind of extends a hand and puts a hand on Blaze's eager and tiny shoulder, trying to pacify him. It looks like they will not be attacking you yet, as Blaze is restrained by Buddy. What an act of kindness. We'll see how that plays out. Now, you are in the room. You are faced with a golden statue that has not moved. Would you like to make any further attacks after entering this room? Do you have a reply, actually? Do you respond?
Do not like the chunky fire guy.
What'd you call me?
It's chunky fire guy. I don't know if I should wait for my team to catch up or if I should make my move.
That's just rude.
What should I do, potato girl?
I'm way over there.
You left all of us alone in this room.
I think I'm gonna attack the gold statue man.
All right, so you attack the gold statue lifting a tankard. Please roll that d20. Let's see what happens.
16.
Oh, yeah. All right, plus your to hit. That is gonna definitely do it. You've got a plus 18 on your normal attack, which means you're coming in for a 34. That is definitely going to hit. Congratulations. Yay. You are just going to smash right through that. Don't even worry about rolling damage, because that was just a plain statue.
Oh, God.
You can remove that from
you trickery.
Yeah, you're just defacing valuable gauntlet property. We will get revenge.
Well, now I'm just infuriated.
All right, tricked. So that's it for you, and that leaves it off to the potato bandit to make any movements while she's vomiting.
I think I'm gonna follow my buddy. I don't know if I can make it to the room. 1, 2, 3, 4.
You're like right in the cusp.
Yeah. I'm gonna go into the room being very careful. I'm gonna leave you. Sorry, she's my bro. I gotta follow my bro. Can't just leave her to fend for herself. She doesn't make great decisions on her own. I don't think.
All right.
And we do.
I mean. Sorry, guys. We got a history that we gotta protect.
In another act of friendship here, we see, yes, as Potato Bandit follows Chunkers bravely into a room of fire, sulfur, and smoke.
Making sure to avoid these little things that I saw.
You seem to be gaining some favor with the crowd.
Yeah.
A quick reminder, of course, $25 for a trap or potion, and if you subscribe during the show, you will be earning them an auto-resurrection, which they are gonna need very soon. Ooh.
We're gonna need?
Oh yes.
Help us.
Oh yes.
Help us. All right.
So now it is back to the Gauntlet's gladiators. So starting it off, it's gonna be Blaze eagerly, get off me, man! And he breaks free of Buddy and he runs forward. He's going to immediately jump between your legs and start like attacking and clawing at your calves over there for Chunkers. Let's see what you got. Ooh, looks like he's gonna go wide with one hand, but the other one is definitely gonna find some nice, soft flesh to beat into.
Oh no!
Sorry,
you hurt my vagina!
All right, and it's gonna be, 16 points of damage as, again, ripping into your calf.
That's a lot.
It's your calf.
Is that how you attack women?
That's how I attack smelly barbarians!
What?
He doesn't mean that, Buddy calls from behind.
I can't tell if these are like good guys or bad guys right now.
He's attacking my calf vagina.
All right, so did you?
You're fine.
Did you take that 16 points of damage on your card?
Oh.
By the way, be sure to write that down. That's going to be important. All right, so. Of course you can. Now, the statues are also going to make their moves. So it looks like the two statues nearest to the door are going to close in on Fido. So if you could please move those statues on either side of Fido.
Can someone get me another skull smoothie? Because this is brutal right now.
That's real brutal.
Oh, you are so lucky. They both just like go wild and like slash over your head and just miss. So painful.
Oh, man.
So painful. But the scythe wielding statue is going to charge after the fleeing Helga.
Ooh.
Okay.
Wait, right. So I did not get hurt at all.
You didn't get hurt at all.
That's great.
But Helga is going to take another 4 points of damage.
Jesus.
The scythe comes right across her shoulder. All right, but that means...
Can I get the potion next, please, baby?
Or maybe another trap.
Sorry.
Oh,
No, not that one. No, the one that I said, please. That's the potion one.
Ooh, potion's boring. No one dies from a potion.
Okay, yeah, well, I'm gonna die from
that. All right, Fido, it's back to you.
Oh, you know what's not boring? Skull Smoothies, guys. Wow, that's an interesting name. What other interesting names are there in the potions deck? I would love to sample them all.
I don't know.
All right, so right
Fido,
now,
yeah, breaking the fourth wall. Go ahead.
All right, I'm gonna go into that room. I think I'm gonna go.
Everyone's doing it.
What is wrong with you people?
He's not afraid of those statues that just tried to kill him.
Oh,
the worst teamwork I have ever seen in my life.
I'm just a lucky guy. I'm just like, yay. Everything can't kill me.
We're just in the corner right there.
Right there?
Yeah.
Okay.
So you enter the room.
Hi, guys.
Get a nice taste of that sulfur.
Welcome.
It's wonderful. Ooh.
And can you make a reflex save from passing through that questionable doorway?
Yeah, yeah. Which D20. One? D20? Yep. Sweet. Let's do this. Zoop! Oh, I thought that was going to be a 20.
I thought you were going to get the natural 20. And your reflex score is only 3?
Oh, really?
Is that what I'm seeing?
Let's see.
Ooh, yeah.
That's not good.
No.
Not good reflexes.
Not so lucky. You're going to receive 2 points of damage as the fangs on top of the door extend out and graze your shoulder. Another nick for old Fido.
Another nick.
Now, would you like to make any moves now? You got a couple spells at your disposal.
Ooh.
You see there's a couple gladiators ahead of you, 2 golden statues chasing after you.
Protect
from
behind. The only strong one.
What would you like to do, Fido?
Also, I'm still stuck back there, and I'm hurting real bad, and I could use some help. Just saying.
That's true.
I'm gonna
that's
go ahead
a that's
say.
A thing. That's also a thing that's happening.
You should definitely help her because this guy might be cool. Like, I know that Chunkers is saying that she's being attacked. It's true, but his big old friend's trying to make him stop. So maybe we can bargain with them.
Big old
maybe
friend's
we don't
trying.
Have
okay.
Him.
And I'm gonna help
and
you.
I hook up with the animals. Okay?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm
true.
I'm gonna help.
Your buddy's trying to smush.
All right. What's it gonna
Sorry,
be, Fido? How are we helping?
Sorry,
what can I do to help?
So you could, of course, use your icy ray, your burning hands, your lightning bolt, or your fireball. You could throw a fireball over at that golden statue.
Ooh,
over there.
I want to do fireball.
Yeah, let's do that. Let's see
I'm
what happens.
I'm on fireball. Boo doo
boo boo doo. Please roll. Oh.
New hashtag trap, the potato bandit steps on a rune and is magically teleported to a distant room of the gauntlet. All that is left behind is a potato. Hashtag horizon.
Sad. Where'd you go?
All right, let's find out. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 options here. All right, let's see what happens. I'm going to roll a dice here, and anything but a 10 will... We'll do it, so... Here we go!
Boo to you, sir, or madame, with the traps.
You are going to appear in the room with the satanic circle right in the center of it, as
oh,
if the ritual was calling you in the center of the circle.
Oh.
Whoa.
You better evolve into some massive
spooky!
Potato.
It's just like magic!
And as you appear... you see in the room you are surrounded by these skeletons who have been performing some sort of strange ritual. So 5 skeletons will pop up all around her if someone wants to place those around there for
me. Why?
My gosh.
Why?
Here, let's do it. Let's do it together.
Yeah, so they seem to be engaged in some sort of maybe like seance where the dead were trying to call the living into their room. I don't know, something
like
that.
Spooky, scary skeletons.
Thank you. Thank you for that trap. That means we'll now have a teleport trap permanently in the trap deck. All right, so as you are teleported in there, you can still make an attack this turn.
I can. Can I not move now? Can I run? Can I flee?
Use your potato powers.
I feel like I should.
You know what, though? I realize we'll get to that in a second because Fido, I almost forgot. He's having his big moment. He's rolling 5d6, so you just roll the d6 once and we'll times it by 5.
The
6-sided die.
6-sided.
Oh, here we go.
What?
Save me, please. Please save me.
Rye, I remember last time, but I will overlook your crime. I choose my way. Hashtag buff for JSA. May you feel the power of rhyme. Prosperous fire, all. Players and users' room gets plus one attack and damage whenever user sings or rhymes on turn. Song, rhyme optional.
Wait.
Wow. Okay, that was a big one. All right, let's think about that for a second, guys. So what prosperous guard just dropped down was straight fire, and it basically says that if you choose to sing on your turn, you gain a plus one on your attack and damage.
Yay!
Woo!
Yay! Yeah, you know what I want to say to Prosperous Guard is, hey now, you're an all-star, I get plus one damage from my fireballs. Thank you, Prosperous Guard. All that glitters is six! And I got a four, but that's okay.
Wow.
Seven that time? And how many more times do I roll?
Stick with that original four. We're gonna times that by five.
Okay.
So that gives you 20 points of damage, but you're gonna gain plus one damage on each of those dice that you just were gonna technically roll there. So we're gonna give you another plus five damage on that. So 25 damage 25. On the fireball. Now the statue and of course Helga must roll a reflex save so that they're not engulfed in the flames.
Ooh.
Good luck.
Mm. So d20 for reflex?
None of those were traps, by the way.
Yes? No?
Yes, d20.
Okay. I got 10, my reflex is 13.
Oh, all right, good news. You only take half damage.
Okay, so wait, half of where I'm already at?
No, so it was 25, we'll say you take 18 points of damage as the fireball consumes you and the statue, but the statue is completely obliterated, leaving just a tiny smoldering puddle of gold at your feet.
Yay.
Congratulations, Fido. Roll that d6, see how many skulls you're getting.
Ooh, this one?
Oh yeah. Nope, that's not a d6. The d6 is the one that you've probably seen the most in your life.
The one for Monopoly. All right.
Yep, exactly.
Five!
Nice.
All right, you're up to 26 skulls with the hour and 33 minutes on the clock. You've gotten a bunch of sweet buffs, and crowd's loving it. You only need about 170 more, points to get the big score.
Yay, okay.
There you go. All right, so after Fido's brilliant display and let me guess, how are you feeling right now, Helga?
Pretty terrible.
Pretty charged.
I'm at 4 HP, by the way, everyone. So thanks for the friendship.
The charred, oozing, half-dead Helga gets to take her turn.
So I'm just gonna, I guess, mosey on into the room where everyone else is. You know, they left me.
I'm not there.
There's no bonus for complaining.
Wow, I might not help you anymore.
I'm gonna slowly. You didn't. You never did in the first place. You set me on fire. Anyway, so I'm just
guys,
gonna.
I hate it when you fight.
I'm just gonna move. I hate it when you leave me alone to die. So yeah, I'm gonna limp my charred, crispy body, leaving chunks of burnt flesh and fur. And just walk on over.
Did someone say chunks?
Yes.
By the way, I'm going to say that singing buff is going to last for two rounds. So you can either use it this round or the next round. Or you can use it both rounds if you're in such a position. Now, are you going to move once or twice? Because you could make a double move here to get closer to the action.
I'll go twice.
All right. So. Be careful through that door.
Yeah, so I'm going to go through the door.
All right, roll a d20. Let's see if you escape the fangs. You do have a high reflex score, though.
I got
Oh, you're
six.
Fine. You nimbly duck and dive beneath the growing fangs.
Wow. Sludge.
So now I crisply make my way through the entrance.
Feeling right at home in a superheated room.
Yeah,
full of fire.
It's great. Takes me back to the good old days in the other room.
Excellent. Well, that leads the way for Chunkers. What are you gonna do? You gotta
this dude is still attacking my vagina thigh,
I don't understand why you keep saying that.
Well, isn't that, that's where his head is on the statue, so I'm gonna just assume that he thinks that's my calf because he's an idiot. So I am gonna try to get this dude off of me. I'm gonna try to
Since he's so tiny, I'm just gonna try to elbow him in the head.
I guess barbarians aren't that good at anatomy. I guess that makes sense. Okay, very well.
You know what? Everything on me is chunky, so they all look the same.
It's hard to tell.
All right.
I am just gonna try to elbow him on top of the head to get him to knock it off. So let's see.
Well, he's already incredibly uncomfortable from all these comments you've made, so I'm sure he'll be leaving
you
alone.
Well, then he needs to get the fuck off.
Are you going
to
be making a power attack or a regular attack?
I'm going to do a regular attack.
All right, go for it.
And that's a 14.
Oh, you are definitely going to hit.
That is one big elbow.
All right, now I need you to roll some damage for me.
Yeah, hold on. It's a 6, right?
It's D12 plus, I believe, what's your modifier on your character sheet? D12 plus...
16.
Plus 16! Jeez, what?
Wow.
That's so good.
No, that's so good.
Why did I make the barbarian so good?
Because I'm barbaric. So which one do I roll?
A 12.
Where's the 12? This one?
No, that's not the
12. Someone find me the dice! Okay.
It's the one with 12 sides.
You know what? I can't count. I'm a barbarian.
That's true.
I got a 2, so...
That's okay.
I'm good.
Still dealing 18 points of damage.
Dang.
Not bad on a 2. All right, so your axe comes clobbering down on Blaze, who is already trying to flee you after everything you've said. And then it's back to the potato bandit, who is now teleported into a
room. Wait, so is he done attacking my privates?
We'll find out.
Okay.
So, potato bandit, you are surrounded by these skeletons who seem as surprised to see you as you are to see them, to be honest. If a skeleton can look surprised. Which we're saying these ones can't.
So I'm gonna just be like, oh, hey guys.
Befriend them.
Are you like potatoes?
What are you doing here?
I was not here, and then I was here, so I couldn't really tell you.
Are you the maiden of the veil?
Yes. Absolutely.
Oh, well then you will purge all the terrible beasts and marauders from the gauntlet.
Nope.
But you're the Lady of the Veil.
You know, I just remembered that I have somewhere to be.
Oh, okay.
I'm sorry, guys.
It only took you 204 years to answer our call.
I'm sorry, you know.
What were you doing?
You called it a really bad time.
We didn't even get, like, a message.
I was making turkey with potatoes.
She was steaming.
Yeah.
I wish I could taste things still.
Yeah, I'm gonna just go this way. You guys,
There's just like a spider crawling out of the skeleton's eye. And they're covered in cobwebs. Videos. They've been there for quite a long time.
3, 4, 5, 6, bye guys, have a good...
The Lady of the Veil will not be allowed to escape!
And wait, after your turn is over...
Wait, I'm gonna sing though. Do 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 do. Do songs.
She must not be the real Lady of the Veil.
And all 5 of those skeletons are going to surround you.
No.
Again.
Dang
and,
it.
Attack you this time.
No, but I did the singing.
The singing does not give you a bonus against fooling skeletons.
But protection, singing, protection, singing.
Protection, singing. We'll see how that plays out. Well, one of them, 2 of them are going to completely just miss. But 3 of them are gonna hit. Let's see how they do. Ooh, bless you. You're gonna take 8 points of damage as they get their claws and rusted blades into your sides.
Gross. Ow, that hurts.
You will remain with us eternally.
You guys need to find a hobby that's not me.
204 years.
No.
Now, of course, Blaze and Buddy are back in action. So Blaze now is like, what? What the hell is she talking about, man?
I don't know. I think these are bad people.
All right, let's kill them. And that's what they're going to do. So Blaze is actually going to target the weakest of the group. Seeing Helga's form emerging through the doorway, he's going to run up and try to just jump on top of your back and grab your hair. Oh, no.
I have a lot of hair. I'm very animalistic, though. Wouldn't you think that someone who's been raised by wolves would be able to quickly arch.
So he's gonna put his fiery paws into you as he climbs up your back, stabbing into you as he does, and he's gonna be doing 12 points of damage as he climbs up to the top, and as he does so, you begin to falter and topple to the ground.
I'm dead.
You are very dead. All right, so he starts dancing on your lifeless body.
Oh, wow, man. That's awesome.
You can remove...
That's what you get for having such a weird friend.
So you are removed from the room, and you will sit out for two rounds as, don't worry, the gauntlet's most bright and brilliant and cunning and truly evil necromancers will rebuild you. Of course, it's a very painful process, but price for mortality is pretty high most times. Now, bless you. And Buddy is going to... He's going to move back one tile, if you wouldn't mind moving him back. And he's going to fling a fireball into that group that's collected there.
Oh, good.
You're all bunched up very nice.
Wow, way to use my move, buddy. You know.
I thought he was trying to save me. I thought he was trying to smush.
But then you attacked his friend.
Well, this is wrong.
It's not fair, but that's just the way it goes. Alright guys, I need you each to make a reflex save, the two of you. So that's gonna be Fido and Chunkers.
With this die?
Which one? D20.
D20.
Plus your reflex.
D20.
Here we go.
14!
Ooh.
I don't have good reflexes though, I'm sad.
That's good.
15!
Alright, I have great news. You're both able to sort of dodge out of the way. The fireball sort of envelops you, but it passes by and smashes against the back of the wall. So you only receive 9 points of damage each from this. Oh, here we go!
Hashtag Fido enjoy a tasty potion bottle, but never forget hashtag Bottlegate.
Nobody loves that.
Good bottle luck, brother, gate. From your friendly neighborhood Cinder.
Nobody
oh! I'm in this mystical realm, I wouldn't know what Bottlegate is. Okay. So this is my potion.
This is the potion.
For Bottlegate.
Bottoms up.
Did you take your damage off?
Oh, look at it. Oh, the crowd loves it. As he
that was for you guys.
Drinks it down, and what did that taste like?
Oh man, it tasted like broken dreams in Cleveland.
Ooh, that makes so much sense.
In the 90s.
Considering what you have just imbued yourself
ooh,
with.
Ooh, a guardian angel! Auto raise from dead upon death. Oh, yeah. Beautiful. Beautiful.
Wow, Fido always finding the
really
best potions.
Thank you for the potions. Wow.
Still gonna point out, none of those were in fact traps. You've had nothing but help from the audience, which is very strange.
You have had nothing.
Except for
nothing.
That one where
very
I got
strange.
Transported to a room full of demons.
Yeah, there was that one time. That one.
Oh, yeah, well, you know, we need more, is all
that
I'm saying.
You know,
as long as it's not me getting into that, you know.
Happened. All right, there's an hour and 23 minutes left. This is the gauntlet. This team right now is trying to get the high score. They're trying to beat 206 points. And of course, you can tip $25 for a potion or trap if you want to help them. And every subscription gets them an auto-resurrection that they are going to need. I'm going to kill another one of them
right now, right?
You guys both took 9 damage. Anyone dead? Did you take your 9?
Me.
Oh, I didn't take my 9.
You better.
Let's see. Oh!
You're not looking too good.
I'll be all right. I got my guardian angel.
That's true. Curses you.
Okay, wait. What was I at before? Oh, my gosh.
I think you were at 22.
I thought it was at 19.
Oh my goodness, of course I forget right now. I'm pretty sure I had 17 left.
All right, so there you go. Now it is gonna be Fido's turn. What are you gonna do after being engulfed in the flames?
You know what?
What are you gonna do, you punk?
You know what I'm gonna do, buddy? I'm gonna use my best pitch. I'm gonna use my icy ray. How, you thought I only knew about plants? Deal with my icy ray right now. Deal with it.
All right, roll. Roll for that icy ray.
What do I roll?
It's going to be a D6.
D6, once. Okay. D6, see? I'm learning, guys. Here we go. Oh, a 2.
All right, so what happens as you conjure this icy ray? How does it look? What does it feel like?
I'm slowly, it's like I'm forming snow. Like, I'm balling up snow, but it's all coming from my hands. So, there's just like a snowball is forming all in my hands.
Wow, and so did you fling that snowball at Blaze or Buddy?
I flinged it at Buddy.
Ooh, at Buddy. So Buddy is gonna take 1 point of damage as the snow gently sort of settles on his shoulders and turns to steam.
Oh, I didn't want gentle snow. Oh well, I'll deal with it.
A nice try.
Does he like the snow? Is he like, oh, that was, you know what? That was very cooling. Mm. Thank you.
Are you trying to kill me or are you trying to set like a nice ambiance?
No, I was, you know, do you know those icy hot patch things? I was trying to do that effect.
I've never heard of such a
thing. It's part of American capitalism. Anyway, I was just trying to have it.
Wait a second.
You can never keep a good wolf girl down. Hashtag Neonet sends one hashtag potion to hashtag Helga. Neonet, maker of the beloved old-time breakfast treat, Sass Browns.
Oh, my favorite. Can I drink a potion beyond the grave?
Kenyon, thank you for that follow. You're being repaired right now. You now have a working mouth. Someone will feed it to you.
Okay, it's getting there, so I at least have... Okay.
That was a really weird way to spell trap, though. That's all I have to say.
Whatever, keep your Sass Browns to yourself, man. Mmm.
Mmm. It must be very good.
I have dry mouth. But it feels very parched now, my dry mouth.
Oh,
yeah? That's what it tastes. It tasted very hydrating and refreshing.
I'm sure it did because the base is water, but then the additive, of course, is ground up newt's eye.
Mmm. I knew that's what I taste. I knew that's what I tasted.
Oh, no.
Gross.
Nice.
All right, what does that do? Can you let us know?
Invisibility. Can't be seen by enemy until attacking. Bonus d6 of damage.
Great. I'll take that potion back. Thank you very much. Now you can activate that as soon as you come back onto the field of battle and start getting that sweet invisibility bonus. Or just, like, you know, hang out invisible the whole time and no one can hurt you.
Yeah.
She's
dead.
Sounds like middle school.
She's
already
invisible.
Yeah.
Oh.
Wow.
Ouch.
All right. Sorry. So you now are being reconstituted, but it will be Chunkers who is next. Chunkers, what are you doing?
So he's not attacking me, right? Okay, all right, well, I still got some power of Chunks left in me, so I'm pretty pissed at this one.
Oh, yeah?
Chunkers,
are we gonna see a power attack?
I don't like this dude, man. He's throwing shit at us, so I'm gonna attack him. Power attack.
Wait, you're gonna attack Buddy?
Yeah, Buddy threw a fireball at us.
Well, you gotta get on the other side of that pool of lava.
Maybe, oh, wait, who's that, Blazer Buddy?
Blaze is the little one.
Blaze is that. I'm gonna beat him up.
Come and get it! I just killed your friend and now I'm gonna kill you! You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna kill you and then I'm gonna beat your friends to death with your body!
I could step on you.
Mean.
Can I step on him?
Sure.
Okay, I'm gonna step on him.
Alright, is that a power attack?
Power stomp.
I'm gonna do a power stomp.
Yeah!
Yeah!
The power stomp! Here we go!
Alright.
Like putting out a flaming bag of poo.
18!
Oh! Wow. That will strike true! Roll that d12.
What'd you call me?
I'm facing
a song. I am going to hit you with my foot.
Oh, there we go. Using the buffs. All right, so you're going to get a plus one damage on bonus. Your teammate is running. Oh!
Chunk this chunky. Hashtag chunk. Hashtag chunkness.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah!
Yeah.
Chunk attack!
Oh. Oh! Here we go. Oh, we're gonna need more potions.
Shots, 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 everybody. Hashtag potion for everybody.
Yeah!
Hashtag Aries, making the world a better place with big FN guns.
Wow. That could have been so many traps, guys.
Yeah.
I'm really disappointed.
Whoever you are, you're awesome, dude.
The love right now from the gauntlet.
There is so much love in this gauntlet right now.
Wait, do I get a potion, though?
You're all going to get a potion, don't worry.
We do like a friendship.
All right. What?
And we have one more potion coming in.
Oh, like this.
We call it the Chunky Chug. The Chunky Chug. It's Pomeranian.
You know what that tasted like? Friendship.
All right, so you each are going to gain
really good rich.
This tastes like Blaze's blood to me.
All right, so you each are getting a new ability, and then Chunkers will actually get a second potion.
Yeah.
So let me refill those vials for you.
Now,
starting it off, let's find out what passed this to Chunkers. Let's find out what Chunkers got.
Chunkers got cure serious wounds. 3d8 plus 15 HP restored.
That's pretty sweet. And then Fido, I believe you dropped one of your cards there, but I believe just picked up a new ability as well.
I dropped both because I had the Guardian Angel.
Oh, wait. Pass that one to the left.
Okay.
To me?
Yeah.
This is mine?
Yes.
Okay.
It'll make sense in a second. Yeah. So what did you get?
I got Shattering Belch.
Oh, very good.
Yeah, so 5d8 damage. It's a range attack. So now I got not only ice going down, now I got belching, and it's an auto hit. So oh my gosh.
And you know what? He doesn't even say excuse me after.
Yeah. I go, accuse me of having a Shattering Belch.
That is just rude.
Brutal.
That is rude. And what did you get?
I got Helga. True Strike. Auto hit.
Excellent. So there you go. One attack at least will land true. This gun.
At least. Ooh.
And then for down at the end here, we've got the Potato Bandit.
Potato.
Ooh. What's your ghost called? Golden Statue comes to help.
Ooh.
Gonna need it.
# Helga notices a goblin throw a potion from the stands directly to her. Apologizing about Bottlegate and the fact that Cinder didn't know she was dead. # sinless.
I believe that was Lissell. Thank you so much for that subscription. Welcome aboard the Ojimbo. This is Hyper RPG. This is the Gauntlet. Right now, you are seeing our adventurers in the middle of this dungeon speed run. They've got an hour and 14 minutes left, and they've got more potions coming to them as well.
More?
That one was for Chunkers.
Ooh.
Oh, geez.
And then Chunkers, I believe that last one was for Helga.
Helga.
It was a potion.
Yeah, it was another potion. Can you believe that? Yeah. It's just raining potions.
Oh, yeah.
Little goblin.
I love rain.
You think this will help you, but it won't.
I love rain, especially when it's helpful rain.
It tastes like wolf's blood.
Oh, of course it does. Go ahead and read what that does.
Bad gas. 3d6 plus 2 damage to all enemies. I am the queen of flatulence.
I feel like we're soulmates. We're gonna come up and we're gonna come up together, and I'm gonna go, you have a Shattering Belch.
I'm gonna fart and you're gonna burp our way to victory.
Yeah.
Wow, you have such a gassy buildup on this team.
They don't call me Chunky Queen for no reason.
Ooh.
Chunky farts.
It kind of seems like they do. Oh God. Oh God.
Why?
That's really bad gas when it comes.
Well, I have to save my tribe and my friends because they all suck. So gotta do our best.
You're not saving your friends though.
Humans weren't meant to digest dairy for an extended period of life.
Or wolf blood.
Or that
wolf blood.
Anyway.
All right, Helga. What did you taste there?
I got. I tasted something a little shocking, a little electrifying, which makes sense because I got Lightning Shriek. Ooh. 3d12 ranged attack.
All right.
One use.
So Helga's lips are tingling.
Lightning.
With a Lightning Shriek, wow. So you guys, you really are the team that's going to belch and fart your way to victory.
Yeah,
here.
We are.
Do you guys have a team name? Now's a great time to come up with one.
Christmas with the Cranks.
Wow, okay. we'll workshop that one. And also, I just want to point out, you got...
Oh my gosh!
Team Gassy Gus.
Alright, both those are names. Alright, so I want to point out as well, you guys may have missed, because the music started playing, but the potion also that the Potato Bandit got allows her to summon a golden statue to help her whenever she chooses.
Yeah.
So you guys now are loaded with abilities. I have zero traps. But I will still destroy you. Don't worry.
Just try us. We have farts.
And belches.
You are you guys are the rudest, crudest group to come through this gauntlet in a while.
Oh, team rude crude.
Team rude.
It's a rude crude.
All right, so I believe we were actually in the middle of rolling for damage on that power attack, weren't we?
Yes.
All right, let's see what you get. Roll that d12.
Or give me damage.
I don't need
5.
5, all right. And how much bonus damage are you doing with your power attack?
Ooh, with my power attack, plus 16.
Plus 16 on that power attack. All right, so that is pretty nasty. And did you do some singing?
I did. I said, I'm gonna stomp
on
my
gosh.
Foot.
She did.
Yeah. And then I did.
All right, so you're doing 22 points of damage, getting in there with that extra prosperous rhyme
out
there.
Out of here, you little bastard.
Ouch. Blaze just gets the crap stomped out of him.
Pulverized.
Maybe literally, I don't know. He's made of fire, so his digestion tract is a little weird.
Ooh. Hey, what are you doing that for?
He screams as you kick him in the face. Now it is going to be back to the potato bandit, surrounded by the skeletons who once believed her to be the maiden of the veil.
So I'm going to go ahead and summon my statue friend.
Yeah, this is a great time for it.
So I'm gonna attack the skeleton right here that's got its back to me for some reason.
Excellent.
You won't hurt.
I just any statue that can fight.
Yeah. So they get summoned on the opposite side of your target. So now that you are flanking, you'll get that bonus to hit and to damage,
yeah,
and get that sneak attack in there.
Yeah.
So let's see it. Roll that d20.
Okay.
Actually, just kidding. Skeletons are immune to sneak attacks.
Aww.
What?
They don't have any vital organs.
You have a skeleton inside of you, and are you weak to sneak attacks?
Yes. That does not prove your point, but yes.
You're gonna sneak attack him later.
All right.
Yeah.
Oh!
Are you gonna dance again?
Jimbo, we are now 2 subscribers away from our next Steam Key giveaway, and you guys now have 2 auto-reses. 3 auto-reses.
Woo!
What the heck? You guys are stacked. You have an hour left. You only got, 20, I think, 6 points. I can't remember. Yeah, 26 points, so that's less than impressive, despite all the help you've been given.
I just rolled for death.
Oh yeah, what did you get on that?
I got a 13.
All right, that's gonna hit. Roll your damage.
Yeah, okay. Is that a 12 or
1d6.
Okay.
You're not a barbarian.
I could be.
Don't try to fool me.
6, what?
All right, you're gonna do 9 points of damage plus flanking, 11 points of damage. That is gonna be enough. They may not be internal organs, but they do crumble into dust when you hit them real hard.
All 5 of them?
No, just that.
What about my other friend? Is he gonna fight one?
Oh yes,
yeah,
they are.
I bet your butt.
Why don't you roll a d20 for them?
Okay. 15.
Hey, that's also gonna do it. With the flanking bonus, that gold statue is gonna start reaping those skeletons with the scythe. Yes.
So how many of them?
So it's gonna be a great harvest. You're only gonna get one.
Okay, that's not that great of a harvest.
Hey, well, scythes are pretty difficult instruments to use, it turns out.
Yeah.
And in war.
That's...
Hey, thanks for the follow as well, Large Bottom, after the subscription. Classy, I love it. All right, so that's 2 skeletons down. That means you get to roll 2d6 to see how many skulls you get for eviscerating them, turning them into bone ash. Also
4.
A great spell component.
I got a 4.
All right, that's a 4.
And I got a 3.
Whoa!
Hey, you're up to 33 points. Things are looking up. That potion really coming in handy there to give you that flanking bonus.
Yeah.
Especially when you're outnumbered like that. I really hate to see things work out like this, but they are working out in the gauntlet at this moment, but now it's the gauntlet's turn. Oh yes. So what's gonna happen here is Blaze is going to get back up.
How? And, I killed him.
You did not kill him.
Ugh.
You actually need to roll a reflex to make sure your shoe's not on fire. Can you do that for me?
Yes, which one's a reflex?
D20, please.
17.
You're good. All right, I'm happy to report that the old fiery elemental does not catch you on fire as you pummeled it with your foot, but it will strike back with a vengeance. What do you think you're doing? Coming in here smashing my face like that. Oh, he's gonna get a critical.
Ooh.
Oh no, it's just gonna be an automatic hit. All right, you're lucky. You're lucky. So he is going to just bite down Harr! And he's gonna try to snap off all your toes.
Oh,
too chunky for you.
Yeah, you are gonna take 14 points of damage as he bites at your foot.
Duh.
Are you dead?
No.
Oh, nope. Man. Not even close, she says. All right. Well, Buddy is gonna back that up.
You leave my friend alone. He didn't have good role models growing up.
Clearly. Jeez.
Ooh, this is a spicy fireball too. It didn't roll below a 4. Feels good. All right, please roll a reflex save to see if you take half damage or the full 24 points.
Uh-oh.
10.
All right, what's your reflex save?
4.
Ooh, just barely. You are gonna be covered in flames. You're lit up like, I don't know, like.
Like a party.
No, I'm not gonna say Christmas tree because I've already used that line before.
Like a party.
Yeah,
it's exactly. Like a Roman candle on the 4th of July.
I have no idea what strange custom you're referring to.
Like a campfire?
Yes, you are gonna take 24 points of damage as you are engulfed in flames.
24 points.
Of damage?
Yes.
I'm not dead.
What?
She has one health left.
Oh my god.
What?
Save my friend.
Well, we have the auto resurrect.
You are, well, that's true.
However, am I allowed to use a potion?
Yes!
Ugh. Oh yeah!
Well, silly you, I'm gonna use my cure serious wounds and restore.
You guys have so many potions! You have like 12 potions amongst all
Not
of you.
Not only do I do 3d8 plus 15 on damage, my HP is restored.
All right, so start rolling that dice. Let's see how much HP you get.
20?
From the healing powers. No, what's it say on there? It says 1d...
3d8.
All right, roll that d8 3 times.
Where's the 8? Is it this one?
It's the one with 8 sides.
Mm-hmm. So 8. 3.
All right.
3.
14. Okay, so 14 plus, was three. It 2 or 3?
No, 3, but yeah, so it's 14 plus 15. Is that it?
Okay, so you get 15 points of health back, bringing you back from the very edge of death.
Wait. So it's plus 15.
Oh, plus 15? Oh yeah, my god, so that's so good!
Plus
that's
15.
So good! So, no, just kidding. Okay, so you
29.
Get like...
29. So I'm at 30.
You just undid all my work!
Yeah!
Just like that.
Take that, sucker!
What happened to the old Gauntlet viewers who wanted to see blood? Who wanted to see failure after failure?
They want to see flatulence!
They
want
to see chunkiness. Blood. Not us, but, yeah. But theirs.
Yeah.
Very well.
I'm a very strong, independent woman.
Yeah.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Well, two more. Those two skeletons are going to get on either side of the potato bandit as they are furious with you for striking down their friends.
You were supposed to lead us into a great age of undeath.
Kawaii potato.
And there's just a giant potato.
Yeah, it's the potato nest.
Oh my.
Yeah.
You are going to receive 10 points of damage as both of them stab into you at once.
Oof.
Do you take my potion back?
I will take your potion back. You may need that later. All right, so 10 points of damage as you are stabbed by the two skeletons, but unfortunately, your enemies are out of moves, and it's time for Fido to... Are you alive?
I am alive.
Excellent.
I have a whole 17 points.
Wonderful.
Same, we're twinsies.
Yay!
Yeah!
All right, I'll see what I can do about that on my turn.
Please don't, I'm so scared. All right, you know what? I don't like this buddy fella. I don't like this buddy.
You talking about me?
Yeah, I'm talking about you, buddy. It's
come
just-
Come down and look me in the face.
I'm going to. I'm gonna look you right in the eye. 1, 2. Oh, I can't go past the lava, though.
Yeah, you can. You're a wizard.
Not made of fire like me. That's gonna hurt you.
Oh, it's gonna go down. Once I get past... Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Can I go on this side?
Yes.
You can go around the edge, yeah.
So help me when I get around this lava, buddy. It's going down. So help me.
You talking to me?
I'm talking to everyone right now.
I thought you were talking to Blaze this whole time.
But
no, you were talking to Buddy. It's fine. That's me. You know all your attacks are ranged, right?
Oh yeah! I'm still gonna come over and do it close. I'm gonna point blank range ice beam. I mean, not ice beam.
I'm not gonna feel too bad killing you since you're such an idiot.
Hit him now!
Hit him now!
Oh, I can hit him now! Oh yeah! I mean, yeah, I knew that.
I was trying to give you a hint there.
I'm gonna ice beam.
No, not the ice.
Wait,
not
he's fire.
Don't do that.
Why do ice beam fire?
Because it'll put out the fire.
Because have you studied just physical relate? There's if I'm gonna douse the fire with my ice.
Okay.
Ice ray.
Okay, the big ice ray.
The big ice ray.
All right, let's see what you roll on that d6, and then we'll subtract one from it to find out how much damage you do.
Okay. Here we go. Come on, Ice Ray.
At best, he can do a whole 5 points.
Yay! A whole four!
He'll do four, though.
Yay!
He'll do four. Congratulations, you have dealt 4 damage to Buddy.
And Fido is just dealing the damage and getting it done. Wow.
Damage is being dealt. It's happening. All right, what are we going to see from Helga? What's going on with you?
Well, I'm dead.
Well,
so
you are. You know
where,
what? You are,
where have I been resurrected?
So you get to resurrect in any room your teammate is in. Mm-hmm. And here's what I would say. You can hang on to your 2 auto reses since this was you're already due to res on this turn. Mm-hmm. And you can still cash those in later.
Okay, I'm going to do that.
All right.
So can I res in any part of the room?
Pick a corner.
Pick a corner?
Any corner.
All right.
I'm gonna nip at him.
I'm gonna go ahead and res right over here, and I'm like make a
ooh,
grand.
I have a proposition for you. If you want to attack this turn, you can burn an auto res.
Wait.
Otherwise, you will just res.
I have 2 auto reses.
You got 2, and then Jim has 1 specifically, or Fido has 1 specifically for him.
Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna burn. Yeah.
I think it's worth it because guess what? You've got 59 minutes and you still need 177 skulls.
Yeah. So wow. I'm gonna come in, real dramatic, auto res in this corner.
Yep.
Make like a little like woo, like ow, like wolf sound, and be like.
That wasn't
hey,
very
everyone,
dramatic.
I'm. You know what? I forgive you for being bad friends earlier. Now I'm back and I'm gonna try to take care of things because now. This little guy, this big guy here, he's got his back turned to me. So first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and hit him with an arrow and try to go right for his neck. From
his
the
neck
corner.
Is all the way in the front.
Well, I mean like the back of his neck.
Yeah, he doesn't have much of a neck, but you can try. Roll that d20.
That's what I'm doing. And then also I'm gonna go ahead and use my true strike.
Nice. All right, so that's automatically gonna hit. Go ahead and roll damage on that. And you know what? Since you're using true strike, I will give you sneak attack damage.
Oh! Yeah. 5.
You are gonna wanna roll, that was unimpressive, but you are gonna roll a d6 for damage. Don't worry.
All right.
That was unimpressive.
The 6, yeah.
D20 could have been pretty cool though. It's not that good.
Whatever. 3!
Great, so you do 13 points of damage as you seem to find one little spot in the neck.
Yay!
Where the fiery, molten body is slightly weaker. Very good. Doing 13
That's
points of
I
damage
do.
To Buddy.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
And now it is going to be off to... Oh, they like it! They like it! All right. Off to Chunkers, the unimaginable.
So I want to finish off this dude because he's apparently not dead yet, so I'm just going to do a regular attack.
Not a power attack?
Well, he should be almost dead now.
I might want to do a power attack.
Power attack helps him get dead faster.
Okay, I'll get him dead the fastest
okay.
with a power attack. I'm going to use my power of the chunks, and I'm just going to stomp on him until he's dead.
Very good.
1!
Yeah!
It's a very light stomp. I'm still kind of weak of him eating my vagina.
I am afraid that you were gonna miss. You were just gonna like.
I'm very.
You're not gonna
chewed
like,
on my calf. Give me a break.
Your calf is kind of like hanging loosely away from your body, so maybe that was an error to use the injured leg.
I wanted to use my power.
You're gonna stumble forward, miss him entirely. He laughs at you. And then it's gonna be the Potato Raider.
Potato
Highwayman.
Yeah, here we go.
Potato Burglar.
Potato Burglar. It's like the hamburger.
Potato Breath.
With...
Oh.
I better have potato breath of delicious.
I went there. Yeah, all right.
It's fine. All right.
Go ahead.
Yeah, right. They don't really have a smell. That's fine. I'm going to go ahead and do some more attacking with my lovely golden statue friend here.
Excellent. Let's roll some d20s. Great. Let's see what happens.
Stoked.
First we'll do your attack, then the statue.
I got an 18.
Ooh, roll that damage.
Yeah.
D6.
I got a 3.
Easy peasy. You're going to take one of those skeletons down, rendering it into bone ash. Ooh. No problem then. Roll for that statue. All see right. What they do.
I got a 1.
Oh.
Yeah.
It turns out Algamar, the Harvest Reaper, is really having a tough time with that scythe. And just going to get completely miss. You need to actually roll a reflex to make sure it doesn't hit you.
Okay.
D20? Yep.
You got a 7.
You are fine. So you dive under the golden scythe as it goes flying over the skeleton and almost takes off your head. But you are safe. And now it is time for the skeleton to get revenge. Oh yes, roll that d6 to see how many skull points you get from defeating that skeleton.
3.
We're gonna get like 3 more points on the board there. So that's 36 skull points.
Woo!
Yeah.
Still a little bit away from 206, but we're getting there. We're getting there. Make sure you're using those potion abilities. I think those might give you.
Wait, can I call another one? Is this like infinite?
No, you only get the one. I'm sorry.
That's okay. I guess I'll manage with
infinite would be very good though. Hey, the Stundy, thank you for that follow. Yeah. Now, it is off to the skeleton here to get revenge for all its fallen friends.
Wow.
And it is gonna miss miserably as there's some sort of like, you know, a skeleton can't cry, but you see like the cobwebs are kind of like falling down the sides of its cheeks.
Aww.
Don't feel bad for
him. You were supposed to be the maiden of the veil. And then it's back to Blazin' Buddy.
Uh-oh.
And he's still having a great time.
Pretty hard to kick me when you're missing half your leg, huh?
And then he's gonna strike you twice.
Oh no.
Woo. All right, so you are gonna receive 32 points of damage as you're gonna get the 1-2 punch from Little Blaze. He's actually gonna jump in the air and do a spin kick that revolves twice, smacking you right in the jaw.
No,
Rai,
I don't like
Rai,
that.
Your trap plans will fail, for I will lay them from beyond the veil. Another hashtag buff for JSA. Laudanum, ignore damage and penalties taken for one round.
Wow, okay, so
Fido.
You've been wreathed. Take a drink.
Is this Laudanum? Wow.
Why does this dumbest person have to get all the credit?
Oh, mean.
Wow, there's a history
delicious
lesson for you.
Laudanum I'm sucking on.
I'm pretty sure he got most of the skulls so far, didn't he? With that
woo!
Attack. The
I'm
audience always the loves
wow,
the wizards.
All right.
So the laudanum has wreathed you
the laudanum's sort of, feeling good right
some
now.
Some sort of strange aura that's gonna make you invulnerable to receiving damage or penalties for a full round thanks Prosperous Guard.
Prosperous Guard.
Again, I think you guys have forgotten that you can actually tip for traps, not just potions. And the cool thing about the trap is that it can be a totally random effect.
Right, they get it.
The whole Matrix, guys, it's a very nice system. I put a lot of time into it.
No.
And it will kill them.
The cool thing about the trap is that there's nothing cool about the traps.
Huh.
Yeah.
Oh, we'll show them. We're going to get a good trap in.
You get to see Fido get excited all the time.
Yeah.
All right, well...
Even though we're about to die.
Till then, Blazin' Buddy will just keep killing you. So you just took 32 points of damage for Chunkers.
Chunkers?
Why?
Yeah, that's right.
Chunkers is dead.
You think you can talk shit to me?
Dang.
You're killing her.
Dang.
I didn't mean to call you dumb.
We lost the barbarian.
Yeah, Chunkers, you know, when you first stumbled into this pit of lava, I thought, hey, maybe they're not so bad. Maybe these are some good guys. But hey, Blaze had the right idea.
You attacked me immediately.
You know some bad people. Are you dead?
I am dead.
Hey, well you get auto resurrected. Oh. Unfortunately.
Yes, yeah. Yeah. Thanks, potions.
Thanks to the subscriptions. Unfortunately, I must allow this to happen. So you'll immediately spawn
Thank
back
you,
into the room.
Subscribers.
You'll spawn back into the room in the corner of your choice.
Save the chunks. Hashtag save the chunks.
Hyper rabbit.
Chunky. At best.
Yes. Yeah!
Where are you spawning in the room?
Me?
Yes.
Oh, I'm spawning right where this bastard was.
Pick a
talking
corner.
Shit.
Pick a corner, any corner.
Oh, well, I'm gonna go to the corner right next to him, because I'm gonna get him.
That's a wise move. You will actually now be able to attack as normal on this turn, thanks to that auto-res. All right, you guys are making my job pretty tough tonight. All right, so Blaze, though, is gonna seize this opportunity, or Buddy is gonna seize this opportunity to blow up the potato bandit and her dreaded statue.
No.
What about
so you? He lobs a fireball over at you. And that is going to do 19 points of damage, unless you can get a reflex save here that allows you to take half. So roll that d20. Let's see how you do.
Do it.
She's got plenty of... Oh! That was basically one of two numbers you could have rolled to fail this. Wow. And you will take the full 19 points of damage, as will the skeleton, which will just immediately melt into a puddle on the floor. Or sorry, the statue, yeah.
I'm dead.
Yeah, wow. So you both melt on into a puddle on the floor. And you are out of auto reses. That's right. You're real dead.
I'm dead.
And I'm the worst person here. Looks like Fido's being pretty scrappy right now. Taking the potions as they come.
Now, Scrappy Fido, what are you gonna be doing this
round? Oh, here's what I'm gonna do, okay? I'm going right after Blaze right now. I'm gonna do a little bit of a snowball ice beam. Blaze is going, Blaze over
Big
there.
Boy.
So I'm
Big
gonna
boy
be doing-
is Buddy. Big huh? boy, oh, little boy.
Little boy?
Little jazz boy. No, that's he's buddy. Going Buddy. He's going after the big jazz boy.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'm gonna do a little snowball, and then Blaze or Buddy, whoever, is gonna be like, oh, it's just gonna be one of those little ice beams again, yeah? And then I'm gonna be like, shite, shattering, belch, and then the belch is gonna, it's gonna be the attack, but it's also gonna be belch.
All right, so roll for your tricky snowball first, and then we'll do the belch.
The tricky, do I get to do two attacks?
Oh, you get to do both with the potion.
Hey, Fido, sing it. Sing it, baby.
Oh!
Sing it, baby!
No Smash Mouth.
Ooh, no Smash Mouth?
Yes, that's true.
Who let the belch out? Who let the belch out?
You managed to choose a worse
six?
Song.
You know, technically the time for that buff has ended, but I approve of your singing.
Who let the belch out?
All right.
Six.
Wow, doing the full 5 points of damage there.
All right, and then I get to do 3d8, 6d8, here we go.
What?
5d8.
5d8?
5d8 for my belch.
Who wrote these?
I don't know.
Outrageous.
This is great.
Boy, when that trap hits, though.
Damn, that belch was shattering.
All right, 5d8. Do you want to just times this by 5?
Yeah, let's do
that.
Boom,
baby.
Because you guys are running out of time.
4!
All right, so 20 points of damage.
20.
Not bad. Not bad at all.
I let the belch out.
So,
me.
The belch seems to shake Buddy to his core, and he lets out a terrible howl as the flames on his body start to dull a little bit in intensity.
Yes.
That's right.
Yes.
All right, so Fido's turn. Wow, what a turn. Oh, come on. Oh, yes.
Oh, dang it.
No.
# Aries trap test for our new Seattle escape room. Trap for Gauntlet Master Riri.
Thank you, Amalar. Thank you so much. Oh, I've been waiting for this moment.
Played us. You played us.
Here we go. Just when you thought it was safe. The foreign critical spiders. Oh, they rush into the room and they will, there are only 3 targets that they can hit. Let's see who they get. 1, 2, 3, roll 4.
Oh,
oh no!
Thanks for the fall.
It must have been that impressive belch that you just put off, because a goblin leapt into the room and they threw a nest of spiders at you. So there's just like this big like orb of webs that breaks open and thousands of tiny little spiders come crawling out of it, crawling all over Fido, and they just start biting
what?
Everywhere.
No.
I am so sorry about that burp, guys. Wow, how rude of me, spiders. I will not be doing that again.
No, you won't.
No.
If you survive.
Oh no.
You are going to take 38 points of damage!
38? That's way more than I have hit points. Good thing I have my guardian angel.
Oh, well, for a moment, a blood-curdling scream.
Oh my gosh! Why spiders?
Yes, comes from Fido as the spiders are filling his mouth and nose and all his orifices.
Ooh.
No! Oh, not even in the eyes! Yeah. No!
But then, all of a sudden, this glow goes across his body, this bright light shines out, and the spiders are completely destroyed! And the only thing that lingers is the effect of this trap, which says that you must speak in an accent for one turn.
Wait, can I say what I said when they exploded out? I went, "You're not insects! You're your own category! You don't have six legs!" And then they all bust out. All
right, for the next round, you will have to speak in an accent due to the foreignness of the spiders.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, it's like Spider-Man.
Starting not now?
We'll start it right now.
Okay. I'm gonna do this one.
Oh! Never thought
sounds
I was gonna
like
say.
One of my allies has decided to watch.
Thanks to the butt cheese. Welcome aboard the Yojimbo. We are one subscriber away from our next Team Key giveaway. Right now, you are watching the Gauntlet. There are 45 minutes left for this team to claim the high score in this dungeon.
Yeah.
And coming up next at 7:30, it's gonna be Cineverse with Adam, Augie, Erica, and Hector. So stay tuned for that for all the latest movie, film, and media news and more. All right, let's get back to it. What a crazy display as the spiders slaughtered your friend and then he was brought back to life by some sort of powerful effect from his potion. Quite amazing. And that means, Fido, it's your turn. You get to choose a corner to spawn in and let loose.
With your farts.
With your accent.
Oh, that was me? Oh,
yeah.
Sorry. Okay. Sorry, these spiders have gotten me going all sorts of crazy right now. What kind of die do I have to... I just have to decide a corner?
Yeah, you still do everything else like that.
I am just so discombobulated right now from... Jeez.
That venom, foreign venom is very powerful.
It's just crazy that I lit up like a skyrocket, you know?
I don't know what that means.
You should have chose that corner.
You know, I just don't know what I'm doing anymore. I'm just picking corners, you know.
44 minutes remaining.
Okay.
All right, so you're taking a corner there?
Yeah.
All right, and what are you going to do? You still have access to your lightning bolts. And all your spells have been refreshed since you died, so you now have the full.
I died, so I have all my spells. You know what? I'm gonna lightning bolt.
Wow, alright.
I'm gonna just, you know, they think I'm into plants, but turns out I have the ice beam. They think I just have the ice beam, turns out I have a bunch of other stuff. Lightning bolt. All
excellent. Right. Roll that D6.
Roll that D6 is my favorite thing to say. Here we go. And we get a 2. That's not my favorite number, but I'll take it.
Alright, so we're looking at a 10 points of damage. Which target are you attacking?
Me?
Yeah,
oh,
what are your boys?
You know what? I kind of want to take a pot shot off of on Blaze, the small guy. I can never get their names right.
Sure, so the lightning is crackling from your fingertips and then goes roaring out at your target and, there's not an ally standing in front of you, is there?
No.
Okay, good. That would have been disastrous. So the lightning is going to course through the air right at Blaze, but he's going to kind of duck and dive. And you're going to barely get him for 5 points of damage.
All right, yay!
You're going to have to do better than that. You're running out of time. You're never going to get 207 skulls.
No!
I'm sick of your sass, Blaze, is what I say.
Fair enough. It's your turn. What else would you like to do?
Thank you for helping me with that.
I'm sick of your sass, Blaze.
I got plenty more of it.
Also, your voice,
it's really annoying, isn't it?
It makes
why don't I just keep talking?
Want to cry. It makes me want to die, but I'm not the one dying right now, and I do a lightning shriek at Buddy. who's still right
in my friend.
In my eye line, and I'm like, yeah, I know he's your friend, but you just killed like a bunch of my friends, and you killed me once like a little while ago, remember? And I hate you also. Your name is stupid, and your voice is stupid, and I kissed your dad once. Oh, lightning shriek! At his brother.
I never even knew my dad.
Aww. I did.
Wow.
You have to make a shrieking sound.
Well, somehow, Blaze's face turns a little red. All right, how much damage are we doing?
3d12.
Secret leader's
mom. 7.
All right, once more.
2.
And once more.
And 12.
Yeah.
Not bad. So that's 21 points of damage. Excellent. So the lightning is going to course through Buddy as Blaze looks on terrified, thinking about his father he never knew.
Wow.
You just have to make one normal attack.
Okay. Hey, Helga, your lightning attack is more powerful than mine, and I feel really sad about that.
Don't worry, I'll cheer you right up because, as long as I'm here. And I'm so close to taking care of this buddy guy.
Yeah, as Buddy is shaking from the lightning, he just says, "Not everything's about you." And go ahead.
Anyway, so as long as he's already shaken, I'm gonna shake his world up one more time, and I'm gonna bomb him. I'm gonna.
You got that bow.
But I have a bomb.
Oh, you got a bomb. You're doing a bomb. Okay.
It's a go bomb ahead. Arrow combo.
Roll that d20 as Buddy is continuing to explain to Fido, you know, life's a lot easier when you don't take everything so personally.
17.
Okay. Plus, what's your hit? Is that a...
8.
Plus 8. I'm afraid that is going to hit. How much damage are we dealing there? 3d6, I believe.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, it is. Yeah. 3d6. So.
Let's see what happens. What kind of bomb did you throw?
6.
What kind of bomb?
A fur bomb.
A real nasty one.
So you like
just a real bad, just real, the worst kind of bomb.
All right, so like a gross, like, popped up fur ball?
Yeah, but that explodes just real bad.
What's inside of it? Like, is there fire inside of it?
Please. Bomb material, explosion material, and then acid.
Oh, okay. All right,
Xenomorph
continue.
Blood.
All right, yeah.
So I got a 6.
6.
I got a 4.
All right.
And I got a 2.
Not bad. You'll do 12 additional points of damage. Oh, boy. Buddy, fire on him is going fainter and fainter. Chunkers, what are you going to do?
Well.
You cashing in that card? That one you already used.
I don't know, they're pretty close to being dead, but we only got 38 minutes left. Ooh. Thoughts. I think I'm gonna use the bad gas. I think one of the spiders got into my butt and I'm gonna fart him out and he's gonna explode everywhere and he's gonna kill everybody.
Alright, so you're trying to smother Blaze in your butt
farts.
Thunder.
So 3d6 plus 2 damage to all enemies.
Ooh, all enemies! Yeah. That's actually real good.
Including the skeletons. They're so spoopy.
That's a big
5.
Okay.
4.
That's 9 points.
5! Oh!
14 yes! points of damage.
The flatulence wins.
It's plus 2, right?
Plus 2.
Plus 2, 16 points of damage. Yeah. These are so good. Yeah. You got like all the best cards.
I'm getting thirsty again. I feel like we could use more potions.
No,
I could
you guys have had enough.
Use a potion since I'm dead.
You know, your bladders
just,
are only
I've
so
big. I farted
out
so much, I'm dehydrated.
That doesn't make sense at all.
That's in the Chompers tribe.
You can't fart so hard that you're dehydrated. All right, so wipe those two skeletons from the table.
You've
and
avenged my
please
death.
Roll 2d6s to see how many skulls you get.
3.
Come back.
5.
Yeah. Yay.
Look,
wow, so 8 total?
Yeah.
Here we go. That's going to put you at 44 skulls. You've got 37 minutes left. You might have a chance if you can take down a couple of these gladiators. So that means it's you have one auto res left, and you could bank that. You could use that right now to come back into the battle and start attacking Potato Bandit.
I still have full HP.
Right, but for the potato bandit.
Oh, sorry, yeah. Wrong bandit.
Yeah,
potato bandit. Yeah, use it.
All right, yeah. I'm gonna do it.
All right.
I'm gonna res.
Choose the corner you'd like to resurrect in, and then tell me what you're doing next.
I am gonna go in this corner and do a sneak attack on Buddy. This is Buddy.
Sure.
Big boy Buddy.
You can try.
Gonna do a sneak attack on him. Gonna just take my dagger and just like right in the back of his neck, like real angry because I died and I hated it. I hated being dead.
All right.
Blech.
So the potato peeler going in the back.
Yeah.
Roll that hit. Let's see what happens.
Oh God! With
oh
the
my
one!
Gosh!
With the one!
You nearly cut your own hand off with it. Jeez.
At least there's only nearly.
Well, at least you got your HP back because you're gonna need them.
Yeah.
It is now time for Blazing Buddy to get revenge.
Cool. So I'm gonna be dead again.
How are you not dead?
So, Blaze now. Oh, which one of you is the closest to death? His eyes are alight.
Three of us are restored entirely.
I mean, it depends on what you mean, because I was just dead.
That is not what I wanted to hear. So he's just gonna go berserk on, I believe that is Chunkers in front of him? Chunkers? Yeah. All right.
Again. You guys have such a sordid history.
This battle is not over, yeah.
Yeah, how is he not dead? I stomped on him.
You're gonna have to stomp even more on him. Though he's not doing super good. He does look like he's glowing brighter than Buddy, if that is any indication of anything useful.
It's all the fart gas that he's absorbing.
Mmm. Yeah. Mm. Well, you know, that might actually help him in this case. Who can say?
Yeah, because he's fire.
Yeah. Alright, you're gonna take 23 points of damage, as he is gonna try to climb up your back and start trying to pull your hair out.
What a perv.
You think this is some sort of game? Well it kinda is. And then Buddy is going to follow up as well. Buddy is going to take two steps back to the edge of the room. If you could move Buddy, please. Yep. And then Buddy is going to toss a fireball at Fido.
We were having such a good conversation. I wanted to befriend him because he was teaching me so much.
Look, you think life lessons come free? And he lobs a fireball at you.
He also hates that accent.
Not a very good one, though. Can you roll a reflex save for me?
Yeah. D20?
Yes. Wow, this is the worst fireball I've ever rolled.
I got a 10.
You're going to take 6 points of damage. It's a little baby fireball.
Yay!
Yeah, you think about what I said.
I am thinking about what you said, my friend. That was really nice of you to say.
All right, you are lifted of the foreign venom. And it is your turn, Fido.
Okay. You know, I kind of like this voice instead. I'm going to just kind of go with it. I kind of like this for my character. It kind of fills me out a little bit, you know? All right, so I'm going to go. Let's see. I am
33
right
minutes left. Whatever you do, make it quick.
I'm gonna 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm gonna get into a better view. I'm kind of, you know, I'm just gonna get over there and then ice ray. No, I'm not gonna do my ice ray. That one's kind of weird. I'm gonna do my burning hands.
You're gonna use burning hands on the thing made of fire?
The ice ray.
You have the worst attacks.
You do have another lightning bolt at your disposal.
Wow!
Lightning bolt.
Wow, thanks!
Lightning bolt!
I really hate to help you like this.
Give him the shock of his life.
Okay, I've got a lightning bolt.
Alright, and this is on Buddy, I'm assuming?
Ow. This is on...
Buddy's looking a little fainter.
Do Buddy.
Buddy's been faint for like 3 turns
is
now.
Well, you know, you should finish your task.
I also didn't.
Is Blaze the one that we had the really nice conversation?
No, that was Buddy.
Dang it. Fine, I'll hit Buddy.
Buddy says, if you respect me, you'll attack me.
Yeah, I'm gonna attack him. We have a special bond. It's really weird.
we really do.
It is.
All right, give me those 5d6.
All right, 5d6. We got a 4.
All right, so you're gonna be cracking in for 20 points of damage.
What it was.
And I'm afraid that if he doesn't make this save, that could spell the end. Oh no! Okay, so the lightning courses through him, and as his body starts to fade away and starts to flick off with all this ash going through the air, he says,
Remember my words!
What? We couldn't understand that.
Yes!
Say that again, buddy!
Buddy is destroyed! Remove him from the board, pass him back to me, and roll 3d20 to see how many skulls you get next.
Yay!
Good.
Three what?
D20.
Oh, man, I'm getting so many skulls for this team, and everyone just says I'm, you know, just kind of the worthless guy.
Yeah,
it kind of
seems like Buddy is the
18!
Seems like Buddy's the only person who believed in you.
18!
12!
Once more.
15!
Holy crap!
45. Ow, I can't.
Yeah.
You know, people just call me the little guy, but
just more than doubled your score. Sorry, as you were saying.
What are we at?
So, you are now up to 89 points.
Yes. Oh my
89 gosh. Points! That is a huge swing in momentum with 31 minutes left in this gauntlet contest. Of course, you can stop them with a hashtag trap or help them with a hashtag potion. Boring,
so
they've already
thirsty.
Done that. We've already seen that.
So
not interesting.
Thirsty.
All right, and of course, if you want to send a custom trap or potion, you can. That is $50 as opposed to the $25 trap. And then if you subscribe, they will get reses, which, again, I don't know why you do that. They don't need the help. Now,
you discourage people from
potato pit.
I just want to win. More like I just want you to lose. So it's going to be off to...
To me.
Helga.
Helga. So I see Chunkers getting attacked with a blaze like on
yes.
on
and you're
her
running
back,
out of time. 30 minutes
back,
left.
So I'm going to arrow right onto blaze.
Okay. All right, roll it.
Sounds like that.
The fart arrow.
Yes.
Roll your d20.
And then I howl like a wolf while I do it.
Wait, how does that go?
Ow!
Wow, that was really beautiful.
Woof, woof!
She's a Pomeranian.
15.
Plus?
She's a Pomeranian. Where is it with my
age? 8!
Ooh, that is gonna hit! All right.
And then 3d6 for damage.
That's right.
Yeah.
6! I was so excited, but
okay.
It's a 6!
All right, so you're gonna be doing 18 points of damage to Blaze.
You better be dead.
The fart bomb rains true, but he is not down yet. Smacks into him. You're gonna need a lot more than that!
Does he at least look like tired or like...
He looks
disheartened.
He looks pissed.
You killed Buddy! He's the only friend I ever had!
And then it's gonna be Chunker's turn.
Oh, if he doesn't die, I am gonna die. how many power attacks can I do? Because I've done like 70.
You should never stop power attacking.
I know, but I feel like he should, whatever. He's too powerful. I'm just gonna use everything that I have left and I'm gonna stop.
All I had to do was just use my Thunderbolt.
Oh, you shut up.
Oh my.
Tensions.
3!
Ooh, that is not gonna do it. I'm afraid you are gonna go completely wide and smash your nice axe into the ground, condoling the blood.
Yeah!
Wow, do you feel kind of bad that you called me the dumbest
slayer? I died from that. I have earned my punishment.
All right, Potato Raider.
You cursed me, you dumb wizard.
I'm gonna move into a better position, and then I'm gonna throw... Sorry, friend. I'm gonna throw a bomb at...
Very well, I accept. Go ahead and roll that
I have
d20.
Very tough damage, I will take it.
I know, that's why.
So the potato bandit is gonna throw a bomb knowing that it's gonna hit
bomb.
The teammate.
Is
it a potato bomb? Are you throwing a hot potato?
I am, yeah.
Scalding.
Wow, this kind of sounds like a
real great potato.
So,
3d6 then?
Mm-hmm. 3d6 as the hot potato goes flying.
Oh, great. 1. My favorite number.
What's going
turns
on?
Turns out potato isn't a good projectile weapon.
I got a 5. It's right. Not a 1.
So
which
you
makes
did us
happy.
7 points of damage as the hot potato goes flying through the air, and then as it hits Blaze, it just turns to mash and falls to the ground.
What do you got? You got a little bit upset.
Dinner is served, though.
Yeah. That was my true plan. Mashed potatoes.
The potatoes give me power.
You know, Chunkers probably needs a snack at this point.
Yeah, I made a snack for you, buddy.
Now, Chunkers, you're going to have to roll a d20 to see whether you get hit by that potato
so
as well.
I'm so sorry, Chunkers.
Sacrifices
six, nine. You know what you're getting into.
That is not going to do it. So the hot, the scalding hot mashed potato, as it explodes off Blaze's exterior.
And I eat it midair.
It's going to sizzle. Yeah, you try to grab it out of the air with your mouth, and it just burns your face.
But in the best way possible.
Yeah, you take 6 points of damage.
It's okay. Yeah.
Wow, is that a beauty mark? It looks amazing.
Ooh!
Wow. Things are turning downright antagonistic on this side of the table.
Hey, I have plenty of crevices on my face.
I was being a dice.
This is just one more burnt potato on my face.
So Blaze, by the way, is like still like trying to like rip out all of your hair, and has like a fistful of it in his hand. Ooh. And he's gonna channel his rage into that fist and try to light your entire head on fire right now. Let's see what happens.
Light your dick on fire.
Good luck finding it. I'm an elemental.
Well,
I think I stomped
here
it off.
Here in the Gauntlet, we don't stereotype like that about elementals and their.
I already stomped it off 1,000 times.
You take 26 points of damage as your head is now on fire.
But I'm eating potatoes.
You are also burned from the potato.
They're good.
They're delicious.
There's like smoke filling the air, and like, have you ever smelled burning hair before?
Horrible.
Yeah, that is filling everyone's
burning
nostrils.
Burning hair with chunky potatoes smells awful.
Fido, as the stench of the burning hair fills your nose, what are you gonna do?
Oh no, I'm gonna leave the room. This is terrible.
Oh, you're gonna abandon your team.
Two, three, four, five,
Fido,
six. What? Oh, I hate burning hair, and no one's being nice to me anyway, so I'm gonna get away.
Excellent. As you do so, you hear a roar from behind you, and the ground starts to shake as our next gladiator enters the gauntlet. Watch that cross chatter. It is going to be none other than Tyrant.
We have a bad history.
I hope you like a weak ice beam. Is this weakness a really bad ice beam that kind of just like flutters across your face?
No one's weakness is a really weak ice beam.
Dang it! That was my one hope.
So Tyrant comes charging into the room. Cheers fill the stadium. It will be splashing around in its bath for now. But we are on to Helga's turn.
All right, so I am going to... I'm so sick of Blaze. I'm so sick of, like, the fact that he still exists.
It's mutual! Why don't you get bent and get out of my room?
So I'm gonna use my invisibility.
Oh, instantly Helga disappears.
And I disappear, so he can't see me. And so while
That's
I'm
correct.
Invisible, I get real nice and close.
All right. Six tiles or right. 12 tiles?
That, like, five tiles.
Okay.
But I get real nice and close at, like, an angle where he doesn't see me, but I'm like perfectly angled, like, towards his jugular, and I let one of those bad boys rip.
Ooh, so you're going for a...
Which also does bonus d6 of damage.
All right. So, from your invisibility, you let loose the arrow he doesn't see coming right for the head. Let's see if you can actually hit him.
D20.
Please.
Here we go.
I'm so sick of this guy. 13.
Oh, and what's your to hit?
8.
I'm afraid it's gonna go wide. Your shot just barely goes like right past his head.
Wide
and behind him, smashing into the wall as you reappear in front of him.
Wide right.
Okay,
sorry. That unfortunately is not gonna coalesce into what you had hoped. And now it is going to be Chunker's turn.
That's it,
Can she finish what she started?
I am full of rage and fire, and I'm going to attack him with my arms this time.
You're gonna attack the thing made of fire with your arms.
Whoa. They're very long.
Actually, I'm gonna headbutt him.
Oh, that reminds me, you're on fire, so you're gonna take 1d4 damage till you stop, drop, and roll.
Well, I'm gonna stop, drop, and roll while attacking him.
I'm afraid you can only do one of those.
I'm gonna roll around
on
the ground.
Oh, so she is gonna drop and roll. All right.
Okay, I'm done being on fire. I look awful.
Now you know you cannot attack if you stop, drop, and roll.
All right, well then I'm on I'm no longer on fire.
You're not on fire.
But I look terrible.
Your hair is pretty messy, but you know. Like one side is missing more than the other, so you might be able to have like one of those cool edgy haircuts.
It actually looks better than before.
Excellent.
I look like Skrillex.
Skrillex? Who is this warrior Skrillex?
Sonny Moore?
He is the court jester of my tribe.
Oh, okay, that makes a lot of sense.
When I was a young girl.
Now, Potato Bandit, you have 21 minutes left as your teammates here have started something that they're trying to finish. Can you end it?
Probably not.
All right, a vote of confidence from the Potato Bandit.
Wow! We did an inspiration.
All right.
Yeah, if only you hadn't killed your inspirational speaker.
Throw your dagger or some shit.
All right, cool. So I'm gonna throw my dagger as Chunkers yells at me and is like, throw the dagger!
Ooh, the dagger is getting thrown.
Great.
All right.
So I'm gonna throw it, only if you promise to throw it back to me later. You gotta pick it up for me.
Hopefully, wow.
Hopefully I don't roll a one this time.
It would really be a bummer if it just flew into the pool of lava and you
Wouldn't
never got it
Wouldn't it be a real bummer if it flew into Chunkers?
Yeah! Already!
I'm okay with either of those outcomes.
All right. Catch!
Okay, look at this one. Look at that. It's a four.
It's almost like you willed the bad roll into existence.
It's not a one.
So your dagger is going to go flying. The good news is it will not land in the pool of lava, nor will it hit our very own Chunkers.
Good.
It will end up bouncing across the back of the wall, waiting for you to pick it up next time you are over on the other side of the room. And now it's time for Blaze and Tyrant to get their revenge. So first things first, actually, the gold statue with the giant axe is just gonna charge Fido immediately with the axe hefted, raised overhead. It gives sort of a alchemical scream.
Don't worry, I'll block it, guys.
Oh, and it's gonna totally miss. The axe is gonna come down and just shatter the tiles at your feet. But doesn't matter. Tyrant is barreling behind the statue, knocks the statue out of its way, and then tries to devour you in one single bite.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah,
beautiful.
You are going to take.
Yeah, I do like the potato.
27 points of damage as it snaps its jaws around you. But Fido is still standing. It seems that he's mostly lost a good portion of his cloak. Some of his magic auras have suffered greatly.
26.
But Fido will still be standing. Now Blaze is pissed. He is going to once and for all try to end what has been happening.
I'm gonna tear your head off!
And so now he's gonna attempt to just smash your hand, your head between his fists and make it explode all Game of Thrones style. Sorry, to be clear, this is the head of Chunkers, of course, his dire enemy.
You killed my best friend!
Oh, and it looks like it's gonna be two hits as both fists are gonna slam into place and that is going to be some serious damage.
No!
It's gonna be 36 points of damage for this one. So he tries to turn your brains into goo.
I'm dead.
You're dead?
Oh, look how excited
you are. Oh, yeah! All right.
Are you gonna get resurrected?
No, you don't have a res left.
Oh, well, I guess screw me.
But it's still after two rounds, right?
You still got two rounds. Yes! Oh, so the hands go slapping forward, and you just see, like, brains and chunks of flesh go flying across the room, sizzling as they are cooked by his flaming hands.
Chunkers won!
I'm dead!
Now it's personal.
Wow,
Blaze.
Very convincing.
What a stupid name, too. Blaze.
Hey!
Oh my god.
Blaze. You're next! Your head looks even softer.
Well, now?
Your name sounds like you're from a DCOM movie in 1998.
Wow, just because I'm from a different kind of tribe of people doesn't mean you have to be so offensive.
Wow, good point. Good point. You know, we should really, these guys have some wisdom to impart. You know, let's get them so we can get these skulls, but these guys really have a lot to say.
I mean, I'm a better person from this experience. I don't know about you guys, but I learned some
17 things. Minutes!
I don't think anyone watching would disagree. You have 17 minutes left, though, to get the high score or be imprisoned here eternally.
Where's Blaze at? Where's this right kid?
Okay. Blaze is where your comrade was formerly standing.
Yeah, so can I use my ranged attacks? Or one of them says 120 foot.
Yeah, you have used both your lightning bolts.
You're also surrounded.
But what about my fireballs?
I would not recommend using fireball.
Okay, what about my icy ray, huh?
You could use your fireball on Tyrant, though.
See, I'm a little I kind of want to go to that other room, just do the final shot, get more skulls for everyone, then go back and just be, you know, that kind of like, that hero, you know?
All right, well,
so you know what?
16 minutes left, you do whatever you want.
16 minutes! I'm going to go back in to this room right here, and I'm gonna fire my ice beam.
Ooh, a icy ray.
At me?
Nope. At Blaze.
At Blaze.
At Blaze.
Will this be the icy ray that finally finishes him?
This will be the brutal jab that finally brings him down.
Roll
so
that D6.
Okay, we're doing it. Oh. We got a 6! Oh boy.
Alright, 5. Whole points of damage done. Absolutely.
Did he feel the thunder?
So you see
or the ice.
The icy ray kind of smacked against him and turned to steam.
But did he go, you little.
You know, I don't think he noticed it.
I've tried.
But maybe Helga will be luckier.
There's no one directly near him right now, right? Okay, yeah, there's mm-hmm. not. So
you're free
I'm gonna
to do what you want.
I'm gonna bomb him. I'm gonna use my next
bombs away.
My next it's you know it's
acid fur bomb.
It's a nasty one. Acid fur bomb.
How do you make these bombs, or how do you harvest them?
Family secret.
Oh, okay, all right.
She wolf whistle family secret. 18.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's gonna be a hit. Yay. All right, roll that 3d6 damage.
4.
All right, she's going. All right, let's stick with that. All right, for expediency's sake, that's going to be 12 plus. Is there any modifier to that? Is that plus 3?
Plus 2.
Plus 2. All right, so you're going to do 14 points of damage. Not bad at all. As the fur and like cat vomit just goes flying all over Blaze.
Beautiful.
And he's disgusted. What is that? And then it's going to be Chunkers still being reconstituted by our necromancers.
Ah!
And then the potato bandit, after seeing your best friend cut down, what are you gonna do?
I'm so angry. I'm like crying angry. I'm like angry sad. I'm gonna go over here and I'm gonna throw some more potato bombs at this little shit Blaze character.
All right.
Well, he's not dead!
It worked so good the first time.
I know. Well, Chunkers is very distracting for me.
In some ways, your own bomb.
4. Great. That's fucking great.
Not ones anymore, at least.
You actually just pick up the potato, and it's, like, already so soft that it just, like, you squeeze it in your hand and you just have, like, a fistful
of potato. And then I, like, eat it, and I gain its powers, and I get some health back, right? That's how that works.
Yeah, you get, you know how much health you get back?
Like 1 point.
No, you get 2.
Oh, yeah!
Wow!
The dice
for the power of potatoes, and what are potatoes? Plants.
Starch.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Mostly starch. Yeah. Now, of course, it is back to the real stars of the show, that is the gladiators.
Ooh.
So Blaze now.
Ooh.
What did you say? He's gonna charge into Helga right now.
And I'm gonna be like,
catching him?
Okay. Perfect.
No, I'm gonna be like, yeah. Yes. Woo!
I'll catch you.
That's what people always do when they.
I'm like, I'm just howling. I'm just howling at him like a wolf.
Unfortunately, so if you could move Blaze right in front of you. So Blaze is gonna go flying across the room.
Wow.
And he's gonna like slide on his belly and like swipe at both your ankles at once, dealing 14 points of damage.
Oof-ta. Mm-hmm. Oof-ta.
But she's still standing.
Oh yeah.
He can't knock her to her feet. And now the golden statue is gonna go. The golden statue is gonna charge after its quarry. That is the little mage Fido. Yes, that's right.
I'm sorry for bothering you!
This time, it's definitely gonna hit.
Ew!
You're gonna take 8 points of damage as that axe smashes into your shoulder. You hear your bones crack.
We could use more potions. We could use more potions.
No, there's no more potions for you.
No, we
could
use
none
more
left.
Last minute potions, please.
There's now only traps and death.
No.
And reconstitution by our talented necromancers
and
at the Gauntlet.
And potions.
Yeah.
And then Tyrant takes her turn, and she's gonna charge the potato wielding mistress, being very attracted to the smell of it.
That's cool. Oh, great. Great.
So she's gonna try to swallow you in the potato whole. Let's see what happens here. Ooh, that's gonna be not too bad. It's only gonna be 12 points of damage as her teeth kind of graze against you. Luckily, they're razor sharp, still splitting your armor open, and new wounds are forming across your body. Now, that is all their moves as she clenches you in her jaws now. I love that. And it's gonna be back to Fido.
Okay.
Am I alive for this turn?
You will come back this turn. Okay. There's 11 minutes left.
11 minutes left. I'm gonna try my icy ray on Blaze and try to get him out of this.
Is this the one? Is this the final icy ray?
The icy ray that will do it.
Roll that d6.
Roll it.
Yeah, you got 11 minutes left, so time is of the essence here.
Oh, I got a 1.
It does 0 damage.
Wait, could you explain how it happened, though? I at least want to know that sure. I impacted something.
So a little bit of snow drifts from your fingertips, and it like kind of like spurts from your finger and then just like flops down on the ground and disappears.
I tried.
Yep.
It's like a Slurpee, but I don't know what Slurpees are though. Sorry.
Whatever that means.
Yeah, whatever.
All right, you may just say all sorts of weird things. Now, Helga, what are you going to do? You are under attack.
Because he's right there, so I grab an arrow out of my, quiver or whatever the thingy thing on my back is, and I take it and I just stab it straight into
Stab him with
neck.
The arrow. Mm. All right, roll that d20 for me.
16.
All right, you're gonna hit.
Beautiful.
You're gonna hit. How much damage are you doing?
5.
Buster, you're doing 8 points of damage on that strike. Not bad. Not bad at all. Definitely better than none. And now the form of Chunkers will rematerialize in the room as the Necromancer spell has taken effect.
Death.
Death is not the end.
Become death.
Now pick a corner to respawn in, and then it will be back to Potato Bandit.
What the f- What the hell is going on over here, guys?
Dude, we're trying to make it work.
I'm here.
All right, Potato Bandit, you have 10 minutes. What are you going to do?
I'm going to run behind this guy and pick up my dagger and then hit him.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
Little Blaze.
Good move, grabbing the potato
this
peeler.
Dude is still alive.
I know.
I'm never going to die.
Okay, well then I'm going to... I am gonna use the power attack on you.
I'll live forever in song.
Wait, she gets to go. Wait, do I get to go? Does she get to go?
No, you only respawn.
All right. It's a 4.
Oh, I see you got your lucky number.
How? 3 1s and 3 4s. How is this? Use your other hand.
You should maybe upgrade that weapon.
I feel
Let
like.
Me upgrade.
What is
That's
this?
Song that
I feel like I've been cursed. That's what happened. It wasn't, that potion was a curse. That was a trap, All secret right. trap.
Blaze luckily didn't even notice that you were attacking him. So he's gonna keep attacking Helga, who's incredibly insulting.
Man.
You take back all those mean things you say and I'll stop.
And, aww.
Wait, Blaze said that?
Yeah.
I don't believe him.
Helga takes 11 points of damage.
What?
As he punches her right in the stomach with a blazing fist.
Oh my god.
Do we get, like, scores for friendship with this guy?
No.
Like, if we
Okay, you want to be friends with him now? He just punched me in the stomach with his blazing fist.
Well, he has some good stuff to say.
Yes, roll a d20 to see if your shirt catches on fire. Your skins.
My skins?
Mm-hmm.
My furs?
Yes, now you are running out of time. 8 minutes remaining.
8.
Oh, you are gonna be okay. You do not catch on fire. Now it is going to be Tyrant's turn. She's gonna swing her tail out at all three of you in front of her now. So that will also hit Blaze.
Boy.
Let's see what happens. All right, it looks like she is going to hit. She's gonna hit Blaze and hit the Potato Bandit, but just narrowly miss Helga.
How
much does she
I'm just
do?
Hanging out.
They will both take 11 points of damage.
God, Blaze has got to be so close.
His fire is dying down, but he's still got a lot of fight left in him. And again, the golden statue is just going to keep clobbering Fido, who is just standing in the same spot that he was last round. Didn't even move. But hey, it works out because it seems so surprised by him not moving that it overcorrected for the dodge that never came.
That's just part of my whole strategy, you know me. Always dodging.
All right, Fido, what are you gonna do next?
I feel like you should use you and Blaze have like a serious like weird connection thing, friendship going on. Feel like you should like try maybe just using the power of persuasion and be like, hey, you're about to die anyway. Why don't you just, you know, you're made of fire, just go into the lava and die a warm, slow death.
You have 7 minutes.
I have 7 minutes. Can I do that?
Just do it. Be like, I'm your pal. Here's
sure.
my advice.
Sure. Roll a d20 and add your will.
Okay. D20. My will is that I would like you to befriend us and then
commit suicide.
And commit suicide so that you could be with your brother buddy, who I also had a spiritual connection with. That's my wish. I got a 9.
Yeah, well, that was almost convincing until you said commit suicide. And unfortunately, your powers of persuasion are not enough to counteract the request that you've made. You can still make an attack, but you will not be swaying him.
Okay.
Why don't you get out of my room? I don't come barging into your room, killing all your friends, do I?
Fair enough. I'm gonna icy ray you again, I know, it's just kind of a
vibe. Did you even do that last round?
I tried, it just kind of, so I'm just gonna icy ray you again, like this, and I gotta watch. Dang it, I'm sorry, dude, we gotta
so the air briefly moistens, and it's Helga's turn.
Briefly moistens. Yeah, so I'm gonna toss another
6 minutes.
One of my bombs.
Please do.
And but it's towards both of them. Too,
absolutely.
Towards both of them.
That explosive power.
3.
Oh my goodness.
It's contagious. I'm sorry.
Roll a d20 again to see what happens.
Oh god. No, I feel like that I should have. 18!
All right, it doesn't explode in your hands. It just bounces harmlessly on the ground and does not detonate. It
fizzles out in like a little funny cartoon way where it's just like
Chunkers is at full power.
Just like that. Now, Chunkers, it's your time.
Now I'm just infuriated because everyone is just not doing good. Right. And I feel like
you who died
me
twice,
being
but
dead was affecting that. So I am just gonna kill this dude.
Great,
with
great, you've got 5 minutes and 17 seconds remaining.
15!
Great, that's gonna hit.
Is he dead?
No.
How much damage are you doing?
Well, it's plus 10 damage. Oh wait, I have to roll this first.
Yep. Oh, that's you want to roll a d12.
Oh, d12. Okay, so this plus 10 damage. Wait, my god, please kill him. 6.
All
wait,
right.
Is that a 9 or a 6? Okay, it's a 6. Plus 10, 16 damage.
16 points of damage. Will that be enough to kill him?
I hope.
Say yes.
I'm afraid not.
What? What?
This game is bullshit.
How does he have more HP than his brother who was huge?
He does in fact have more HP than his huge brother.
Ow.
You shouldn't judge a fire elemental by their size.
If I'm judging his sassiness by his weakness.
Yeah, his sassiness indicated a high challenge rating, actually.
They didn't truly listen to his older brother.
4 minutes!
We got those.
That's right, okay, it's not
behind.
The size of the fire elemental is just how hot they burn. Who's next?
I went around him, and I'm gonna try to do a sneak attack from behind.
Please use your other hand.
Hey, look, it's five!
Hey, once again, total failure.
What even is this? How is this happening?
Clearly,
it's called chance.
You have brought dice curse upon yourself.
Yeah.
All right, so this time, Tyrant is going to try to devour Helga whole. Let's see how that goes.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, it's gonna be a miss, though. She's just gonna smash her snout into the tiles. No damage done to you.
Blaze.
Next up, it's gonna be Blaze. Blaze, again, continuing to try to bring the pain to Helga. Ooh, you are so lucky, he misses completely.
Wait, stop moving!
And he won't hit you at all, but the golden statue has an attack to make. This one will hit for 9 points of damage on Fido.
I'm at -2.
Yep.
That means I'm dead.
Guess what? You also have 3 minutes left in the gauntlet, and you need to get 111 more points or something. Less than that, actually. But about 100 points. So, Helga.
Okay.
Get those 100 points.
He's still right by me, right?
Yeah.
Still? Yeah. So I'm just gonna, I'm straight into the jugular again with another arrow. Just
okay.
Straight.
Roll it.
Straight in.
Arrows to the head. Not even time to string
15.
Them. Okay, you're gonna hit on this one.
Damage.
4.
Okay, so you're gonna do 8 points of damage, and guess what? So, you stab him right through the head with that arrow, and even though it's disintegrating as the flames catch it, He is going to fall lifeless to the ground. Yay! You have defeated, please. Yes! Now roll your 3d20s and get ready to kill some more enemies.
Wow.
Yeah.
Two. Oh,
yeah. That is two.
Seventeen! 19! We all still have some funny.
127 points is your new total!
Woo!
You got a chance here. You need to kill some more enemies. The Chungus Among Us, what are you gonna do?
I'm gonna throw my axe at him. And I'm gonna stab him in the mouth.
At Tyrant or the statue?
It's the statue.
All right, Wyodell, thank you for the follow. All right, the statue going down. Let's see what happens.
Because he needs a die. Three.
That is not gonna hit.
All right.
All right.
Even with your impressive to hit.
All right, cool. Six, right behind the statue. Here we go. And
eight.
What's your to hit? What's your to hit?
Eight.
It's not gonna work.
My total to hit is 10. Does that make a difference?
Even with your attack there, you get a plus 10 with your melee. Oh, plus 10, actually, that's gonna do it.
Yeah!
You actually hit.
Whoa!
Roll your damage. Let's see if you destroy the statue.
Is it the...
It's about a minute and 15 seconds. D6.
Four.
Yes.
That's gonna do it. Okay, roll a D6 and see how many skulls you get.
Oh.
One.
Oh.
Not great, not great. Okay, Tyrant is gonna swipe her tail out at the two of
but
you.
But it's dead. Blit. Get out of here. Fuck you.
Yeah, that guy sucks.
All right, so, there's only one person in front of her. So Helga, you're gonna take 17 points of damage. And Fido is being reconstituted by the necromancers. Helga, it's your turn. Can you get another kill?
Yeah, arrow.
All right, roll it.
Oh God, 15.
All right, plus, you got a plus 10, right?
Four.
Okay, that's gonna do it.
Yep.
We'll do 8 points of damage. All right.
Seven.
Who's next?
You got a seven.
Seven plus? Are you power attacking?
I am. So with minus 4 to hit plus.
That's actually gonna hit.
Ah! Yeah.
Roll. 12.
Ah! Everyone stop yelling. 9.
Plus?
9 plus 10.
Wait. Aren't you power attacking?
Yes.
18.
Oh, it's 18.
18
plus 18.
Okay, all right, next up, we've got a Potato Raida.
13!
All right, plus 10, that's a hit.
Six.
Oh my gosh, I am so sorry as you are viciously striking the scaled beast. Time runs out and everyone is locked in a magical force field, essentially, of stasis. That is the Gauntlet, your final score tonight, 128 points. Woo-hoo. A little shy of the 207 you needed to best the top score of 206, but a valiant effort. Some really amazing moments here. We learned about friendship. We learned about rolling dice. We learned about mashed potatoes. Incredible, incredible display of showmanship.
Kawaii potatoes.
What a match. I just want to say, guys, thanks so much for being here for the Gauntlet today. Yeah. Before we go off to Cineverse at 7:30, let's get a poll going in chat real quick and pick an MVP who deserves to come back to the Gauntlet again. Otherwise, your characters are all going to be killed.
Oh, no!
Now, as they are voting, you guys each, give me your favorite moment in this Gauntlet. Starting with Fido.
I really liked that my icy ray was really weak because it was just kind of fun pumping it out, you know, like, this is what I got and it's not a lot, but I'm making it work. I thought that was cool to do.
All right, there you go. There's Fido's favorite moment. And Helga.
I liked it when Fido started speaking in a silly voice.
Aw, thank you.
Agreed. And what about you, Chunkus?
I liked when I first started because I seemed so, like, big and mighty.
Okay.
I beat the golden guy.
You did that.
And then I went in the room like a champ. And then I blew.
And abandoned everyone.
Yeah.
That was great.
Like a champ.
I liked the part where we all shared a friendship potion.
Aww.
Friendship!
That was a good one.
Killzone 1740, thank you for the follow. Now, all right, if we could wrap up that poll, we'll find which character is allowed to return while the others will be absolutely obliterated forever.
Talk that buddy and I had too, I forgot to mention.
Oh,
that.
Yeah.
The heart to heart.
The one where you told him to kill himself?
The one where.
No, sorry, that was Blake.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yes, the moment where Buddy taught you about, you know, not...
chilling out, not making everything about myself. That was good.
It's an important lesson for Fido. Hopefully he survives this encounter.
I hope so too.
Hey, Pyro Trojan, thanks so much for all the follows, guys. That's awesome. Yeah. We are one subscriber away from our next Steam Key giveaway. And do we have a winner? Helga is the winner! Helga!
Nice.
I'm sorry that we're going to destroy your friends, but you will be allowed to continue on future gauntlets. Are you a ghost dog?
She's a Pomeranian.
Oh, okay. Now, all right, go ahead here. Let me know who you all are. Jim, who are you?
I'm JSA, and I'm an Oregon Trail streamer. I stream Oregon Trail every day. For tomorrow will be 140 days in a row of it.
Yay, that's impressive. Plus, you're a host of Off the Trail every Thursday at 1 p.m.
Yeah, that's true. And my dad's going to be on the next one. We're going to hopefully be playing some Liberties Kids, which is a Revolutionary War game.
That's right.
So check that out. Yeah, it'll be fun.
I will.
Speaking of, who's this to your left?
I'm Sally, and I'm Jim's dad, who will also be on Off the Trails on Thursday. Surprise! Thursday, from 1 to 3. Jim's dad, Sally.
Okay, find Jim, Sally's dad on Off the Trails. Now, who else do we have here?
Oh, I'm Lisa Wallen. On Twitter, I'm Rock_Lisa. I talk about a lot of anime. I'm a stand-up comedian and a Zelda theorist, and Sally's pet cat's evil rival.
Wow. You rival her in your ability to pet
and
cats.
I'm on here sometimes when they want to book me. So, bookie, here I am.
Showbiz.
Not really.
You should definitely check out Lisa's stuff. There's some of it is on YouTube. It's really funny.
All right.
I was like, I was like, if I have to watch this and pretend like I like it. But no, it was awesome.
Oh.
So, well done. Now, next up, who do we, Koopakins, who are you?
Koopakins. So I go by Koopakins. I go by Koopakins on the internet, and I stream and do YouTube and work at a coffee shop, which is rad.
And you bring us awesome coffee.
I do stream coffee.
So basically, you can come back whenever you want.
I didn't know that. Can I have some coffee around here?
All right, so go check out Koopakins as well. She's really awesome. Hopefully we'll be having her back again soon, as we will the rest of you. Thank you all for participating in the gauntlet tonight. It's been a pleasure to be your GM, Rai, the not-so-evil guy all the time. And next up is Cineverse, so get ready to talk movie news with Adam, Augie, Hector, and Erica. We'll be right back.
Yeah, bye.